$1 million. Ole Venstrom signed to a player agreement by Delaware. Cody Oaks did not report to the Delaware Thunder as part of that trade, so he has been released on waivers, as you see us there on Thunderbirds TV. As you can see, I have my red adorned, red dress shirt, red tie. It's fantastic. It's a fantastic atmosphere in here. It's going to be, for lack of better phrase, actually, I believe it's the correct phrasing. It's going to be absolutely nuts, bonkers, crazy, wild. The roof of this place is going to blow off. As much as these two teams and these two fan bases are not only fond of each other in a good way, but a bad way too. Remember the melee? Yeah, it was the same two teams. Right before COVID shut down the entire planet, Andre Nietzsche and that stanchion right over there at the red line was beating it down, trying to get it to Jerome Bouchard, who will be on the bench opposite Garrett Rutledge tonight. These two teams don't like each other. They never have. And who knows? They may never will. We'll dig deeper into the matchup, take you around the scoreboard of the FPHL. It's a busy Friday night. All that and more. They get you starting lineups and then puck drop for what might be the game of the year, at least so far, for Carolina. Thunderbirds, River Dragons, rivalry renewal. Stay tuned. It's coming up next.
Think driving a third-row SUV has to be boring? Don't compromise with your next SUV. With an athletic-looking performance to match, the Acura MDX is modern, stylish, safe, and designed to thrill. The 2023 MDX adds peace of mind with complimentary maintenance for 2 years or 24,000 miles. Visit us at 425B Silas Creek Parkway in Winston-Salem for a test drive or shop online at flowacura.com.
Ava's Cupcakes is the Triad Sweet Treat. The Season 4 winner of Cupcake Wars has been featured on Food Network and NBC's Today Show. Ava's Cupcakes are expertly handcrafted with fresh ingredients. Treat yourself today. National shipping available at avascupcakes.com.
Use artificial intelligence in new ways to detect strokes earlier than ever before. More peace of mind, since we're the only system in our region that provides pediatricians on demand 24/7. More freedom, thanks to the one and only place around to provide a brain surgery so advanced it requires no incision. Novant Health. Expect remarkable.
At Flow Volkswagen, we make it easy, transparent, and fun to find the perfect SUV. Step into the fun, versatile, turbocharged Volkswagen Taos with 4Motion all-wheel drive and loads of tech at your fingertips. Get into the stylish and versatile Volkswagen Tiguan, designed for every lifestyle. With a wide variety of SUVs in stock, get the right Volkswagen for you. Come in today, schedule a test drive, or shop online at FlowVolkswagenWinstonSalem.com.
Hey, you can expect more. More days ahead, thanks to the first in our region to use artificial intelligence in new ways to detect strokes earlier than ever before. More peace of mind, since we're the only system in our region that provides pediatricians on demand 24/7. More freedom, thanks to the one and only place around to provide a brain surgery so advanced it requires no incision. Novant Health. Expect remarkable.
Brett Wiseman alongside you, Jose Bahena on technical assistance, along with our good buddy Logan Allen, his girlfriend slash buddy Haley, and my father, Matt Wiseman, who so generously decided to give us some technical assistance tonight as well. Hi, Dad. He's right over there. Hi. Let's go around the FPHL scoreboard. If we should or shall, Binghamton and Watertown, in-state rivalry, big crowd expected tonight at the Watertown Arena where Carolina was 8 days ago. Wolves hosting the Black Bears, that one coming up at 7:30 as well. Rivalry renewal as well between Port Huron and Motor City, the league's newest rivalry. As the Prowlers and Rockers get going from Big Boy Arena at 7:30. That, a pivotal matchup in the Continental Division as Carolina jumped Motor City in the third, so now Motor City sits fourth, Port Huron second behind these Columbus River Dragons. Elmira and Delaware, they'll do battle from the Delaware Fairgrounds Center Ice Arena in Harrington, just outside of Dover, Delaware. Carolina won both trips up there this season. They'll get going at 7:30 as well. 7:05 Biloxi time, that means 8:05 everyone else in the league's time. The Seawolves hosting the Danbury Hattricks from the Mississippi Coast Coliseum. Again, that one getting on the way at 8:05. Coming up next in our pregame show, we'll take you through the starting lineups. We'll also tell you a little bit about the Columbus goaltender, Brendan Colgan, whose shutout streak is now a league record. We'll break that down a little bit more and maybe try to piece together a little bit what Coach said in his pregame interview, as well as how Carolina can finally get a puck past Brendan Colgan. All that more coming up next on the Honda Can-Am of Winston-Salem pregame show. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
You can expect more. More days ahead, thanks to the first in our region to use artificial intelligence in new ways to detect strokes earlier than ever before. More peace of mind, since we're the only system in our region that provides pediatricians on demand 24/7. More freedom, thanks to the one and only place around to provide a brain surgery so advanced it requires no incision. Novant Health. Expect remarkable.
Are you looking to reach a larger audience with your business? Bring your business where the people are. There are multiple ways to advertise with the Carolina Thunderbirds: social media, broadcast, in-arena signage, and more. Over 47,000 people attended Thunderbirds games in 2021-22. Can you really afford to miss out on an audience of that size? The eyes and ears are already here. Your business should be too. Call Carrie Ross at 336-270-1029 for more information.
Whether you're a Division I athlete, an avid runner, or just someone who likes to move, you deserve the expert care of the region's most experienced sports medicine team. We're the official health provider for over 35 pro, collegiate, and youth sports organizations. We offer same and next day appointments, and our goal is to get you back to your game and keep you active. If you want to finish strong, start here. Atrium Health, Wake Forest Baptist.
After the success of the Vanilla Coffee Porter, the Carolina Thunderbirds and Fiddlin' Fish Brewing Company are back with another instant classic. The Thunderbirds Blonde Ale. Smooth and easy drinking, it's the perfect beer for cheering on the birds. Don't delay, because these cans are limited edition. Get yours at the game, in the grocery store, or visit us at Fiddlin' Fish on Trade Street.
Salem Fairgrounds Annex on our Honda Can-Am of Winston-Salem pregame show. Brett Wiseman alongside you as we continue to count you down to puck drop. Let's tell you a little bit about this shutout streak that's going on for Brendan Colgan of the Columbus River Dragons, who is in net tonight for Columbus. It stands right now at total game time played, 256 minutes and 1 second. That is by far and away a Federal Prospects Hockey League record. Now, what Coach was saying in his coach interview, which you heard on WTOB, if you could take his eyes away a little bit, standing in front of him, not always the key. The key is to stand in front of him and move around a little bit. Change the direction his eyes are looking. Get him to move, look around the puck, look through people, try and see around bodies. There has to be traffic, active physicality in front of the net, but also active sticks. Changing the direction of the puck when it comes from more outside points, high point, left point, right point, high slot. If you're not right down in front of the net, you've got to get sticks active and try and tip pucks past him. He's on four consecutive shutouts as part of that 256 minute and 1 second league record shutout streak, which Carolina hopes to break. Starting lineups coming up right after this. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
Experience engineering excellence in a brand new SUV from Audi Winston-Salem. The Audi SUV family is packed with expressive styling and progressive technology. Make your daily drive thrilling with the performance of the Audi Q3. Take on new challenges with class and style in the adventurous Audi Q5. Come in today and get 3.99% APR on select Audi models. Schedule a test drive or shop online at AudiWinstonSalem.com.
Finish strong. Start here. Atrium Health, Wake Forest Baptist.
Maple Chase Golf and Country Club offers the best in recreational amenities in the Triad. Come enjoy a meal at the Pine Brook Bar and Grill. relax by our pool and cabana, gear up at the pro shop, and sharpen your skills on our 9,000 square foot putting green, and play around on our 18-hole Ellis Maples Design Championship Golf Course. Find out more at MapleChaseCC.com.
After 15 years of the Share the Love event, Subaru and our retailers have donated over $250 million to charity. Subaru is the largest corporate donor to the ASPCA and the National Park Foundation, and the largest automotive donor to Meals on Wheels and Make-A-Wish. Get a new Subaru, and Subaru and our retailers will donate $300 to charity.
Want to get in on the action? Bring your friends. With group packages of 12 seats or more, tickets start at just $12 a person. Group packages are perfect for church groups, youth groups, business outings, and more. Come together to see your Thunderbirds. Call 336-748-3949 today.
The name right, Storjahan is one of the starting defensemen. Storjahan, I should say. Alex Storjahan is one of the starting defensemen for the Columbus River Dragons. Jacob Kelly, one of the starting forwards, along with Ryan Gill. Paul Frejo will be alongside Alex Storjahan on the back end. He's actually a forward. I misread that. So they'll be out there along with Ryan Gill, Jacob Kelly, and Josh LaBelle will be the other defenseman. And it will, of course, be Brendan Colgan in net with his 1.73 goals against average. Starters for Carolina, Lucas Rowe, Jacob Schnapp, and the new guy, the big fella, Matthew Bazarin, number 20, will be in the lineup to start off on the forward line. Victor Grebennikoff and Joe Kennedy will be on the back end, and Mario Cavalieri will be in net for the Thunderbirds, bringing with him a 3.39 goals against average and an 892 save percentage. Take one more break here on the Honda Can-Am and Winston-Salem pregame show. When we come back, that's hockey time. It's a redout. This is going to be fun. It's already so loud in here, you can't even hear yourself think. Where else would you want to be? Best rivalry in the league. Let's do this thing. We're back after this.
Ava's Cupcakes is the Triad's sweet treat. The season 4 winner of Cupcake Wars has been featured on Food Network and NBC's Today Show. Ava's Cupcakes are expertly handcrafted with fresh ingredients. Treat yourself today. National shipping available at avascupcakes.com.
Use artificial intelligence in new ways to detect strokes earlier than ever before. More peace of mind, since we're the only system in our region that provides pediatricians on demand 24/7. More freedom, thanks to the one and only place around to provide a brain surgery so advanced it requires no incision. Novant Health. Expect remarkable.
At Flo Volkswagen, we make it easy, transparent, and fun to find the perfect SUV. Step into the fun, versatile, turbocharged Volkswagen Taos with 4Motion all-wheel drive and loads of tech at your fingertips. Get into the stylish and versatile Volkswagen Tiguan, designed for every lifestyle. With a wide variety of SUVs in stock, get the right Volkswagen for you. Come in today, schedule a test drive, or shop online at FloVolkswagenWinstonSalem.com.
Hey, you can expect more. More days ahead, thanks to the first in our region to use artificial intelligence in new ways to detect strokes earlier than ever before. More peace of mind, since we're the only system in our region that provides pediatricians on demand 24/7. More freedom, thanks to the one and only place around to provide a brain surgery so advanced it requires no incision. Novant Health. Expect remarkable.
Are you looking to reach a larger audience with your business? Bring your business where the people are. There are multiple ways to advertise with the Carolina Thunderbirds. Social media, broadcast, in-arena signage, and more. Over 47,000 people attended Thunderbirds games in 2021-22. Can you really afford to miss out on an audience of that size? The eyes and ears are already here. Your business should be too. Call Carrie Ross at 336-270-1029 for more information.
Whether you're a Division I athlete, an avid runner, or just someone who likes to move, you deserve the expert care of the region's most experienced sports medicine team. We're the official health provider for over 35 pro, collegiate, and youth sports organizations. We offer same and next day appointments, and our goal is to get you back to your game and keep you active. If you want to finish strong, start here. Atrium Health, Wake Forest Baptist.
After the success of the Vanilla Coffee Porter, the Carolina Thunderbirds and Fiddlin' Fish Brewing Company are back with another instant classic. The Thunderbirds Blonde Ale. Smooth and easy drinking, it's the perfect beer for cheering on the birds. Don't delay, because these cans are limited edition. Get yours at the game, in the grocery store, or visit us at Fiddlin' Fish on Trade Street.
Experience engineering excellence in a brand new SUV from Audi Winston-Salem. The Audi SUV family is packed with expressive styling and progressive technology. Make your daily drive thrilling with the performance of the Audi Q3. Take on new challenges with class and style in the adventurous Audi Q5. Come in today and get 3.99% APR on select Audi models. Schedule a test drive or shop online at AudiWinstonSalem.com.
Think driving a third row SUV has to be boring? Don't compromise with your next SUV. With an athletic look and performance to match, the Acura MDX is modern, stylish, safe, and designed to thrill. The 2023 MDX adds peace of mind with complimentary maintenance for 2 years or 24,000 miles. Visit us at 425B Silas Creek Parkway in Winston-Salem for a test drive or shop online at flowacura.com.
Fairgrounds and Expert Wiseman alongside you as we get set to go. The FPHL's best rivalry renewed as the youth and sled hockey players of the game make their way off. That's former Thunderbirds captain and current River Dragons captain Josh Petrantonio that's skating over to meet his former teammate, Thunderbirds current captain John Butita, for tonight's ceremonial puck drop. As the gentleman making the ceremonial puck drop's got a Wake Forest Club hockey jersey on. They're actually playing after our game tonight. There may be some things they might have to do extra ice cleanup after this one. It might get a little bit physical tonight. It's a red out. This place is sold out and ready to rock and roll. Bazarin, Rowe, Schnapp, Kennedy, and Grebennikov, the five for Carolina. Greco, Frejo, Storjahan, Gill, and Kelly, the five for Columbus. Sit back, relax, and enjoy this one from Winston-Salem. Columbus off the opening draw, shoots it in back of the goal. Cavallari plays it ahead for Grebennikov, takes the hit. Rowe hops back on this loose puck, back of the goal for Kennedy. Joe Kennedy stretch pass ahead for Schnapp. Schnapp around Storjahan, gets it in deep. Picked off by Frejo. Frejo up the ice. There's a pass over for Gill, hit a skate. I believe that was Bazarin. Now a stretch pass picked off, intended for Rowe. Now this one picked off at center by Kelly, shot on goal and gloved down by Cario Cavallari. Here comes Bazarin. Through center. Bazarin uses that big frame to get the puck in deep. Chipped up. Schnapp keeps it in play up around the dasher. He'll get off for a change. Frejo. Back of the goal. Waiting for reinforcements. Watched by Peter Panacek as the check line comes out. As pass picked off at center by Firth, who fans on the pass for Pastuca. He gets it though and gets it in deep. Austin Doe has it picked off. Salak's return feed for Panacek through his legs. Bione holds it in at the line. Now this one, baseball batted down and sent ahead for Alexander Jamayev. He gets it into Doe, who is blasted by Bione near side. Firth trying to hop on this one. Bione's on the loose puck now. Backhand to the head for Pastuca. Too far for Salak. All the way down. This might be an icing call. Nope. Colgan's got to come out and play it. Gave it away. Oh, Salak missed an open net. Oh, goodness. That would have stopped the streak for sure. Jake Cox is on the loose puck. Back of the goal now. Sent over for Wickline. Shoots one wide. Pietrantonio holds this in at the line. Firth battling back of the goal with Cox. Martin ahead for Butsita. Finds Panacic. Panacic backhands it in deep with a whack from behind by Jake Krupp. Another familiar name. This pass almost picked off by Keplinger. Martin's got it at the red line. Trying to dangle around Krupp. He does. Butsita. Ford could not stay quite onside as Carolina had numbers. A golden opportunity that was missed. Salak had a wide open net after Colgan made the rarest of rare mistakes he's made in the past 258 minutes and 19 seconds of game time. 17:42 remains. Here in our opening frame. Storjahan v. Ford in the circle. Top line back out after the offside. Shots even at one. Ford wins the draw. Kennedy's got it. Kennedy gets it in deep back of Colgan. Played around the wall by Greco and out to center. Storjahan stretch pass too far. Kennedy wins the race, but icing was waved off. Martin, indirect pass for Keplinger. He's got it on his backhand. Watched back of the goal by Gill. Keplinger backhands this up for Butsita, who will chip it out to center. Greco, after Ford blew a tire, feeds it over for Jacob Kelly. Here's Kelly, watched by Keplinger. Kelly able to muscle it down low. Kennedy hops on the loose puck, ahead for Keplinger. Carolina will try and break this out. Here comes Joe Kennedy, leaves it for Butsita. Butsita gets it in deep. Kennedy, he's on this. Takes the hit, gets it back of the goal. Cox blows a tire, watched by Keplinger. Keplinger hops on the loose puck, finds Ford. Here's Gus, over for Rowe. Too far, he's got it back of the goal though. Lucas Rowe, with speed back out top, forced out of the zone. A number of guys blowing tires here so far. Rowe dangles through center. Here comes Lucas Rowe, in on goal! Poke check by Colgan. Oh boy. He turned the Columbus defense into a personal chew toy right there. Did everything but score. Kirk Underwood, backhand pass for Doe is picked off. Firth and Rowe battling. Rowe and Doe. That was fun to say. Schnapp gets it out, but not out. Held into the point by Adam Vanelli. And now taken away by Vanelli from Blake Peavy, who sees his first action of the night. This one is chipped in deep, but Firth skips it ahead for Schnapp. Touch fast for Peavy. Here's Peavy on the backhand, tried to drop it back, took a hard hit, and now Grebennikov hit from behind by Jemeyev. Here's Panacic, a wrist shot that's blocked. Loose in front, Schnapp, too far for Peavy. Firth tried to hold it in, Peavy will. He'll get it back at the goal. Good forecheck from Carolina. Here's Panacic. Skates out top. He's going to exit the zone and reset. Pass hit Salak in the back of the foot. And now he'll have to play it back for Bione, whose pass is tipped. Pastuca feathers off wick line. Here comes Panacic. Panacic through center. Dangles around. Shoots one. Colgan, I should say, makes the save with 15:11 to go. Frantic action so far. Carolina should at least have a 1-0 lead if Salak had to miss that wide open net. As the former Thunderbirds receive boos in their return. Finally, puck is dropped. Panacic can't win it away from Wickline. Pass back of the goal. Here's Krupp. Krupp plays it ahead for Salak. Made a business decision to get out of the way of Big Jan. As here comes Bione. Touch pass for Salak. Picked off by Rogers. And now Salak picks this pass off. Hit from behind. But gets it deep past Wickline. Wickline shoots it out to center. Fumbling the puck. There was a River Dragon. Now Panacic dangles around Jay Krupp. Here comes Peter. Peter centers it for Pastuca, drops it off for Salak. Salak shoots one that's blocked. Panacic hops on the puck. Panacic feeds it into the middle, picked off by Petrantonio, and he'll weave back at the goal for Rogers. Rogers. Stretch pass, touched in deep by Storjahan. Cavallari will play it behind his own goal for Bione as Carolina will try and break this out. Kelly picks it off from Salak. Frejo moved out to center. This will go all the way down. Should be an icy call. No. Some reason that one was waved off, and Kennedy's got to come back and play it. Stretch pass ahead for Butita, who was in behind the entire defense, but he was offside apparently, and it's an icing call, actually, since he didn't touch it, with under 15 minutes to go here in our first period. We'll take a 30-second timeout, first of the night. Shots are 2-1 Carolina, but they and Columbus are scoreless.
At Flo Volkswagen, we make it easy, transparent, and fun to find the perfect SUV. Step into the fun, versatile, turbocharged Volkswagen Taos with 4Motion all-wheel drive and loads of tech at your fingertips. Get into the stylish and versatile Volkswagen Tiguan, designed for every lifestyle. With a wide variety of SUVs in stock, get the right Volkswagen for you. Come in today, schedule a test drive, or shop online at FloVolkswagenWinstonSalem.com.
In Salem, Brett Wiseman alongside you. Technical assistance from Logan Allen and Jose Bahina as the, it's not a complete sea of red tonight. Some folks didn't quite understand the assignment, but most people did, including my broadcast assistants. I must say, Haley, one of our other helpers, has the 25th anniversary Sebastian Aho jersey on right now. I've got to say, that's the best Canes jersey of all time, and it should still be the permanent one, but what do I know? I was born the same year they moved here. Anyways, back to the game at hand. Storjahan enters the faceoff dot. V. Ford off the icing call with 14:04 to go in the first period. One by Ford, Kennedy, Bione, now Keplinger. Plays it back to the goal for Bione. Kelly is chasing after this. And he's hit from behind by Kennedy. Poked free Keplinger. Trying to weave this out, and he will. Here comes Big Josh through center. Over to Butita. Butita, back of the goal. Centered one for Kennedy. Couldn't get there. Bione recovers at center. Bione. Touched in. Frejo. Plays it over for Greco. Greco, center of the ice. Kelly. His pass could be picked off by Bione. Touched for Ford. And Ford hops on this loose puck. Cross-ice Kennedy at the red line. He'll bank this in deep. Back of his own goal, Colgan. Nearly gave it away right there in front, did Kelly, as here's Martin on the loose puck. Martin stretch past Butita, was offside. That's going to be an icing call. Either way, it was not going to end well for Carolina with 13:08 to go here in our opening frame. Shots remain 2-1, Thunderbirds, as Columbus has yet to sustain much of an attack, and if Jan Salak didn't miss a wide-open net, we wouldn't be scoreless. Vanelli gets this in deep, shooting it indirectly back at the goal. This one picked off, though, by Jemayev. Played out top by Underwood, and now set back in deep. Firth is on the loose puck. Tried to get it to Butita. That was picked off. Firth hops back on it. Danny Martin. Blind backhand pass for Firth. Stretched ahead. Knocked down at center by Keplinger. Here comes Lucas Rowe. Rowe shoots one that hits a stick and goes up into the netting and out of play. .12:38 remaining here in our first period. As Rowe, with one of the other good chances so far for Carolina, dangled through the entire defense and did everything but score. He'll take the draw. Columbus wins it. Played back of the goal. Now the pass is fanned on. Krupp's going to get this. He can't get it out as he's hit hard by Bazarin. Bazarin watches Petrantonio. Petrantonio for Rogers. Look out. Here comes Schnapp. He lays the body in. Petrantonio trying to skate this out around Rowe. Firth as it's stopped up at center by Petrantonio, who's bodied from behind by Rowe. Pass was tipped and picked up by Rowe now, who will get it ahead for Schnapp, who will backhand this over for Danny Martin. Bazarin trying to feed this in. Here's Rowe. Rowe shoots one, save, rebound, just wide. Two good chances for Rowe right there. As this one shot out to center through the legs of Danny Martin, he'll chase back after it. Krupp watches him. Schnapp tips it in deep. And Carolina will get off for a line change. Here's Frejo. Stretch pass ahead. This should be an icing call. Don't believe he had the red line. Nope, waved off. Kennedy back of the goal. Gill out top. That one shot wide by Greco. Played down low by Kelly. Storjahan in a battle with Pastuca. Gill trying to muscle this free. It comes for Grebennikov. For Kennedy. Feathered ahead for Panacek, and out comes the check line. Here's Panacek moving left to right. Wrist one that hit a stick of a River Dragon and goes up and out of play with 11:10 left in our first period. And Gus Ford will hop on here on the offensive zone draw. Grebennikov will head off, so Ford will be the fourth forward. Interesting little shift here. Panacek trying to muscle it free off the faceoff. Frejo back at the goal. Greco, bank pass for Gill. Gill's pass can be picked off by Bione nearly as he read it well. Here's Kelly. His shot was blocked. Salak trying to backhand it out. Bione is able to get it free out to center. Frejo for Greco. Greco wrists it in deep. Cavallari will catch it out of midair with the glove and make the save as Gill and Bione come together with 10:45 remaining in our opening frame. Shots now 4-2 Carolina. Kirk Underwood to take the draw. Opposite Keplinger with Butsita. And now we're going to get a discussion from our officiating crew as there's a point, there might be an issue with the ice here as the one and only Paul Jackson is going to skate out and yeah, he deserves that kind of ovation. Gotta love Coach Paul as he's out to correct whatever the issue is here on the ice near side. Maybe a wet spot. We'll keep it here while we wait. This game is still scoreless, and yes, the shutout streak is continuing for Brendan Colgan. But he almost lost it, really, of his own volition on a mistake that I guarantee you he's lucky he got away with. He kind of fumbled it back of the goal, and it was picked off by Panacek and then thrown in front to Salak, whose shot was tipped at the last possible second by a Columbus defender, it appeared. And Salak flat out missed a wide open net. Whether it was tipped or not, the net was open. Colgan had not made it back into the blue paint yet. That was the first good chance. Lucas Rowe dangled through three, maybe four River Dragons, got on goal before Colgan poke checked it free. As Coach Paul skates off, and we should be ready to go back to action here. The sellout crowd continuing to fully file in here. And there seems to be a lot more red in the building. Might be some Wake Forest folks here too. Might stick around for the college club hockey doubleheader. Firth plays it back in the goal for Bione off the faceoff win. Butsita ahead for Firth. Here comes Tucker Firth over for Gus Ford. Ford shoots it on. Colgan made the save. Rebound tipped wide. Keplinger battling for this loose puck. Moved out towards the neutral zone. Firth is able to hold it in somehow. Ford moving in. Shoots that one blocked. Butsita trying to play this out top. Jemayev to center. Firth, D to D, Bione's got the red line. He'll get it in deep all the way around the wall. Colgan lets it go. Ford trying to pinch. Knocks it deep behind the net. Vanelli has it picked up. Here's Rowe in front. He shot it wide. Oh, boy. Third great opportunity. Keplinger, cross-ice Firth. Shoots, glove save, Colgan. 9:48 to go. We'll take a 30-second timeout. Carolina and Columbus are still scoreless.
After 15 years of the Share the Love event, Subaru and our retailers have donated over $250 million to charity. Subaru is the largest corporate donor to the ASPCA and the National Park Foundation, and the largest automotive donor to Meals on Wheels and Make-A-Wish. Get a new Subaru, and Subaru and our retailers will donate $300 to charity.
Back to action here in Winston-Salem. Lucas Rowe in his own end. Dangling around, stick handling away from Wickline. Here's Grebennikoff ahead for Peavy. Here comes Peavy. Rowe able to stay onside behind the play. Peavy's pass was blocked, and it's golf clubbed back out to center. Wickline nine irons this out of midair and gets it in deep. Cavallari, backhand pass. Martin couldn't find Rowe. Schnapp, though, able to hop on this loose puck. He'll get the red line, take the body, and backhand this, at least as far as the Wake Forest logo. That pass tipped by Peavy. Here's Rowe. In front, Rowe missed again. And this one whacked up and out of play. Did it hit the glass first is the question. I believe so. That was Jay Krupp, I believe, that tried to whack that puck off the glass and out, but it appeared to hit the top of the stanchion there and then bounce directly out of play. Remember, if it hits the glass first, or if it hits anything before going out of play, it's not a penalty. Panacek in the dot, takes the draw, wins it. Salak has his pass whacked out to center. Kennedy hops on the loose puck, backhands this in deep. Is barely missing the official on that one. Frejo, pass is picked off by Panacek. Salak trying to muscle it in front. Gill hops on the loose puck, and out come the River Dragons. Gill gets it in deep. Cavallari back of the goal. Plays this up ahead. Off the wall. Panacek for Bione. Stretch pass Pastuca. He is able to touch it. Salak bodies a man back of the goal. Frejo. Pass picked off by Pastuca. Over for Salak. There's Salak. Chips it around a defender. Big Jan in front. Score! The streak is broken! Peter Panacek! 1-0 Thunderbirds! How do you like that? The league record long shutout streak is over! We'll pause 10 seconds for station identification. This is Thunderbirds Hockey. There may be some folks in Columbus, Georgia that thought they might never see this again. Here comes Gus Ford in on goal. It's poke checked, and Colgan's able to stuff his pad down as Carolina had another great scoring chance. And this place is so loud right now, you can't hear yourself think, breathe, anything. Eight minutes to go, first period. Here's Keplinger. Scores! Josh Kemblinger, 2-0. What a shot! And Columbus is stunned. They can't believe it. They haven't dealt with this in 2 weeks. They don't know how to react right now. 2-0, Carolina. Bazarin off the face-off win. Pass is picked off. Schnapp will get this in deep. Peavy's after it. Hit from behind by Bazarin. Peavy forechecking hard. Out top, held in by Martin. Martin, pass in someone's equipment. That one picked off for Wickline. It's ahead. Wickline smothered by two Thunderbirds at center. Now Bazarin for Kennedy, ahead for Schnapp. Schnapp, return feed from Peavy too far. Shot in deep. Cavallari will stick this down and backhand it around the wall for Schnapp. Schnapp around the wall at his own end, ahead for Bazarin. Picked off by Rogers, shot in front was blocked. Peavy diving. Played back. Petrantonio, shot blocked by Schnapp. Petrantonio blocked again by Schnapp. And out of play. Oh, Jacob Schnapp, you beauty. Stepped in front of two rockets from the former Thunderbird captain. .658 to go here in our first period, and the Thunderbirds have a 2-0 lead on the best team in the league. Firth, back of his own goal. Pass is picked off at the blue line and now gloved out of midair and nine ironed out to center. Rogers from Petrantonio gets this in deep. Back of the goal, funky bounce for Cavallari, ahead for Firth. Back of the goal, Bione. Plays this ahead. Pastuco whacks it out of midair, able to force it out. Center, Petrantonio for Rogers. Slap shots it on goal from the red line. Cavallari settles this down, plays it for Firth. Stretch pass, Pastuco. Pastuca, cross-size Panacic. Here's Panacic. Shoots one on. Colgan sticks it up and out of play. The 6:17 to go in the first. Check line will stay out there. Bione and Firth on the back end. Panacic wins the draw. Now Frejo trying to get it out. Panacic pitching down the wall. Puck is loose in the high slot and now taken away by Columbus. Out comes Austin Doe. Doe and his own man collide. And now a stick breaks as Pastuca is able to wire this one out. Should be an icing call, though. And it will be. As tough to tell whose stick broke there. It may have been Jemayev. .556 to go, opening frame. Shots are 9-3 Carolina. Score is 2-0. You want to talk about an opening period statement, you got one. Panacic and Underwood in the dot to take the draw, won by Bione. Firth bangs it up and out. Salak gloves it down. Pastuca, no hand pass is the call on Jan Salak. .549 to go, opening period. Thunderbirds have a 2-0 lead. Keplinger in the dot to take the draw. Off the hand pass. Out to center, Frejo shoots it on. What a glove save by Cavallari. Snared it right out of midair. Keplinger to take the draw yet again. Greco out top. Shot hit a body and went into the deep far corner. Keplinger bodies his man off. Here comes Rowe. Dangles this around a man. Rowe is checked down. Should have been a penalty maybe. Should have been interference. But a no call as it appears they're going to let him play tonight. Keplinger is blasted out at the red line by Underwood. And Underwood picks this pass off now. Head for Jemayev. Picked off by Kennedy. Stretch pass looking for Ford. Rose pushed from behind and thrown down. And now here comes Ford. Gus Ford dangles around. Gus on the backhand. Chest save. Colgan. 5:08 to go as Rowe is again shoved down. Well, he's obviously the target right now. And now Rowe's going to go off for a penalty. For a cross check. Okay, good. We got matching minors. Okay, Rowe wasn't him. As he shouldn't have been. Greco goes off. He's barking. But everybody in the barn saw that cross check. And it's a Carolina power play with 5:08 to go in the first and a chance to add to a 2-0 lead. Peavy, Butita, Schnapp, Pastuca, and Ford are the five on this unit. Peavy can't win the draw, but Butita and Schnapp are on this loose puck. Played over for Peavy. Peavy back of the goal. His stick lifted by a defender, played over for Schnapp. Schnapp near side for Pastuca, far side Ford. Ford, cross-ice feed again for Schnapp, deflected on goal. Colgan made a couple of saves. This one is played out past Pastuca as Schnapp takes a shove from Petrantonio. Cavallari back of the goal ahead for Ford. Ford drops it back for Pastuca, dangerously in front of his own goal. Now Petrantonio picks off this pass. Wick line in shorthanded. Cross-ice feed tipped. Now back of the goal, Ford hops on it. Minute 20 to go on the power play. Ford. Cross-eyes Butita in the middle for looking for Schnapp. Now it's picked up by Pastuca for Schnapp. Shoots one. It's in. It's tipped in by John Butita. Power play goal. 3-0 Thunderbirds. Schnapp may actually get credit for it as it might have hit a defender. But it's in the net. And Colgan is shaken. Schnapp gets credit for it right now, and now Greco's going back in the box. There's another 2 minutes on the board to Greco. What is happening? See if we can figure this out. 4:16 to go, first period. Greco's original cross-checking minor is the only one on the board right now, but he's back in the box and there's 2 more minutes. Keplinger wins the draw. It's another Thunderbird power play. Kennedy over for Rowe. Rowe back of the goal. Head for Panacek. Peter dangles through center. Kennedy, head for Panacek. In deep, held in though by Joe out top. Here's Salak trying to muscle this puck free. Here's Panacek behind the goal. Down below the goal line, out top Kennedy. Kennedy near side, Panacek. Panacek assesses his options, finds Salak, now Keplinger. Keplinger trying to bank that off the boards for Panacek, now whacked back out to center. Played over for Kennedy. Ahead, Rowe. For Panacic. Here comes Peter. Down the near side. Looking into the middle. Instead, we'll skate out high. Dor Kepler shotgun on goal. Colgan made the stop. Shot down and shorthanded is Kelly. Over for a shot on. Dor Jahan missed an open net. Golden chance shorthanded. And Dor Jahan flat out missed it. He'll skate back out to center with 45 seconds left on the penalty and 3 minutes left in the period. Unsportsmanlike conduct was the penalty call. Here's Underwood in shorthanded. What a save by Cavallari! Right on the doorstep, Underwood stuffed by the Thunderbird goaltender. We'll take a 30-second timeout. Carolina leads it 3-0, late going, first period. Where shockwaves are ringing through the FPHL wires and score checks. The Thunderbirds have a 3-0 lead on the seemingly unbeatable Columbus River Dragons. With 35 seconds left on Michael Greco's second penalty in as many minutes. .250 to go, 30 seconds left on the penalty. Ford, trying to play this up, pass Underwood, does for Peavy. And a late call of an offside. Butita was close to touching back up there. With the faceoff, we'll come into the neutral zone. .239 remaining, and they're going to bring the faceoff to the opposite end of the red line, as that's where the pass came from. Faceoff won by Carolina, too cleanly though. Played back by Pastuca with 15 seconds left on the Carolina power play. Ford into the zone. Looking backdoor for Peavy, tipped on goal and a save by Colgan. Ford down the wall. Trying to feed it into the middle, picked up by Peavy. Plays it back for Schnapp, penalties expired. Peavy going to muscle this out top, away from Underwood. Pass hit Schnapp in the back, settles the puck down, tries to spin around and shoot it on his forehand, but it was blocked. 2 minutes left, first period. Columbus trying to break out and find a way to get a rush going here. Doe for Greco. Greco, near side, shoots one on. Pad save, Cavallari. Keplinger moving through center. Turns on the Jets. Hits the red line. Now gets the blue line in deep. Kennedy down low. Trying to muscle it in front. That pass banked off the wall out to center. Rowe chasing after it. Hops on edge. After Grebennikoff and an icing call now with 89 seconds remaining in our first period. Rowe will take the draw. Grebennikoff, Bazarin, Keplinger, Kennedy. Minute 25 to go. Rowe. Can't quite get this. It is cleared out to center. Keplinger gets it in deep. Rowe touches back up onside with a minute 15 to go in the opening frame. Greco. Out towards center. Played by Kennedy. Ahead for Bazarin. Bazarin for Keplinger. Keplinger feeds it in the middle for Rowe. That one poked away by Greco. Read nicely. Kennedy with a minute to go in the first. Head for Rowe. He'll touch this in deep. Well, he definitely looked like he got a piece of that after two River Dragons collided. That wasn't just one blown tire. That was the whole back end of the car at center ice. As in frustration for such, someone just broke their stick on the bench. ...53 seconds left in our opening frame. Carolina's a 3-0 lead. Behind the goal, Gill muscled off the puck by Kennedy. Rowe trying to force this free as well, pinning Gill to the boards. Kelly hops on it, shoots one high, may have been deflected. Played back in deep. Bazarin will lay a hit to Frejil. Keplinger banks it off the wall and not quite out, held in. Schmidt had it taken away by Keplinger. Back at the goal, Grebennikoff with 20 seconds left of the period. Grebennikoff will bank this up and out. Takes a hard check from behind. Frejo is touched in deep. Storjahan, slap shot. Cavallari made the glove save. Was trying to go low to the glove side. With traffic in front, Cavallari saw around the screen, snared it from right off the ice surface, basically, with 9 seconds left in the first. Kelly can't get the shot away with 5 seconds left. Martin banks it up. Frejo can't get there. Salak chasing after it with two with one, and that'll do it for period number one. Well, if you wanted a first period statement, you got it. The league's best team is down a bundle after the opening 20 minutes. The Columbus River Dragons trailing the Carolina Thunderbirds in front of a sellout crowd here at the Winston-Salem Fairgrounds Annex. Shots are 12-7 Thunderbirds, and they lead it 3-0. We'll break down what was a wild first period here at Winston-Salem. Take it for scores around the league and more on our intermission report right after this. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
Think driving a third-row SUV has to be boring? Don't compromise with your next SUV. With an athletic look and performance to match, the Acura MDX is modern, stylish, safe, and designed to thrill. The 2023 MDX adds peace of mind with complimentary maintenance for 2 years or 24,000 miles. Visit us at 425B Silas Creek Parkway in Winston-Salem for a test drive or shop online at flowacura.com.
Ava's Cupcakes is the Triad's sweet treat. The season 4 winner of Cupcake Wars has been featured on Food Network and NBC's Today Show. Ava's Cupcakes are expertly handcrafted with fresh ingredients. Treat yourself today. National shipping available at avascupcakes.com.
Use artificial intelligence in new ways to detect strokes earlier than ever before. More peace of mind, since we're the only system in our region that provides pediatricians on demand 24/7. More freedom, thanks to the one and only place around to provide a brain surgery so advanced it requires no incision. Novant Health. Expect remarkable.
At Flo Volkswagen, we make it easy, transparent, and fun to find the perfect SUV. Step into the fun, versatile, turbocharged Volkswagen Taos with 4Motion all-wheel drive and loads of tech at your fingertips. Get into the stylish and versatile Volkswagen Tiguan, designed for every lifestyle. With a wide variety of SUVs in stock, get the right Volkswagen for you. Come in today, schedule a test drive, or shop online at FloVolkswagenWinstonSalem.com.
Back here inside the Winston-Salem Fairgrounds Annex on WTOB 980 AM, 96.7 FM, AM 1470 WWBG Greensboro, and here with you on Thunderbirds TV. As you can see, I did understand the assignment. I have my red adorned. And who else understood the assignment? That was the Carolina Thunderbirds. Objective number one, be the first team or first person, really, in four games to get a puck past Brendan Colgan. They succeeded at the 11-minute and 46-second mark of the first period. Peter Panacek from Janselak jamming one in behind Colgan ended the league's record-long standing shutout streak. And finally, somebody can say they scored on Columbus for the first time in 2 weeks. Thunderbirds were not done, though. 17 seconds later, Josh Keplinger sniped one going Bardowski behind Colgan to make it 2-0 Carolina. Again, not done. Michael Greco, penalty for cross-checking at 14:52. On that power play, Janselak from John Butita muscling one home to make it a 3-0 game. Now, Jacob Schnapp originally got credit for that goal. Butita appeared to maybe have tipped it, but Salak is now the one that's credited with that power play goal at 15:44. Directly after that, though, Greco received another penalty for unsportsmanlike conduct. Carolina got a shot on that power play, but were unable to score on it. Mario Cavallari made a series of great stops there down the stretch after Carolina was heavily outshooting Columbus, and then Columbus finally got the wheels going a little bit. Shots stand right now, 12-7 in favor of the Carolina Thunderbirds. The score stands, yes, 3-0 Thunderbirds. And that should be sending shockwaves around the rest of the FPHL as the league's best team, 22-2-1 coming in, has been spotted 3 in the opening 20 minutes here in Winston-Salem. We'll tell you what's going on around the rest of the league and more after this on our intermission report. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
Hey, you can expect more. More days ahead, thanks to the first in our region to use artificial intelligence in new ways to detect strokes earlier than ever before. More peace of mind, since we're the only system in our region that provides pediatricians on demand 24/7. More freedom, thanks to the one and only place around to provide a brain surgery so advanced it requires no incision. Novant Health. Expect remarkable.
Are you looking to reach a larger audience with your business? Bring your business where the people are. There are multiple ways to advertise with the Carolina Thunderbirds. Social media, broadcast, in-arena signage, and more. Over 47,000 people attended Thunderbirds games in 2021-22. Can you really afford to miss out on an audience of that size? The eyes and ears are already here. Your business should be too. Call Carrie Ross at 336-270-1029 for more information.
Whether you're a Division I athlete, an avid runner, or just someone who likes to move, you deserve the expert care of the region's most experienced sports medicine team. We're the official health provider for over 35 pro, collegiate, and youth sports organizations. We offer same and next day appointments, and our goal is to get you back to your game and keep you active. If you want to finish strong, start here. Atrium Health, Wake Forest Baptist.
After the success of the Vanilla Coffee Porter, the Carolina Thunderbirds and Fiddlin' Fish Brewing Company are back with another instant classic. The Thunderbirds Blonde Ale. Smooth and easy drinking, it's the perfect beer for cheering on the birds. Don't delay, because these cans are limited edition. Get yours at the game, in the grocery store, or visit us at Fiddlin' Fish on Trade Street.
Experience engineering excellence in a brand new SUV from Audi Winston-Salem. The Audi SUV family is packed with expressive styling and progressive technology. Make your daily drive thrilling with the performance of the Audi Q3. Take on new challenges with class and style in the adventurous Audi Q5. Come in today and get 3.99% APR on select Audi models. Schedule a test drive or shop online at AudiWinstonSalem.com.
Now on our intermission report, Brett Wiseman back with you inside the broadcast booth inside the Winston-Salem Fairgrounds Annex. Carolina Thunderbirds lead the Columbus River Dragons 3-0 after the opening 20 minutes of play. Let's take you to Delaware where the Thunder are hosting the Elmira Mammoth. Not a lot to report there after one period of play. It's still scoreless. They're about 6 minutes into period number two. And shots now stand 15-14 in favor of the Delaware Thunder. Let's head to the state of New York where the Binghamton Black Bears are putting it to their in-state rivals, the Watertown Wolves. Shots are 15-6 in favor of Binghamton. They're able to get on the board at 2:41 into the game. Nikita Ovashkin from Josh Newberg, that made it 1-0. 3 minutes later, Tyler Jurich from Gavin Yates, that made it 2-0. Elijah Wilson for Watertown failed on a penalty shot for Watertown, a momentum keeper, if you will, for Binghamton. And at 15:09, Gavin Yates on the power play from Cameron Yarwood and Tyson Kirkby made it 3-0. Travis Smith pulled, replaced by Gregory Hussey, as Watertown again has to make a goaltending change mid-game as they did last weekend in Carolina. Ivashkin second of the game at 19:24, the first period, made it 4-0, Binghamton. The important one for Thunderbirds fans, it's a 3-2 game between Port Huron and the Motor City Rockers right now. 61 seconds into that one, Laurie Vartiainen from Evan Foley. That made it 1-0. Declan Conway tying things at 1 at 4:37 for Cade Lambdom and Scott Koch. That made it a 1-1 hockey game. Jonathan Giuliano from Tim Perks and Cade Lambdom. That made it a 2-1 Motor City lead, 7:47 to go. 11:32, mark of the first period, Austin Federley from Adam Heinzel. That tied it at 2. And then Federley from Johnson and Wyatt Hofflin made it 3-2 at 16:29 of the first period. That's where we stand right now after one period of play. Second place, Port Huron leading fourth place, Motor City, 3-2. It's a 1-0 lead for the Mississippi Seawolves right now. That's a bit of a shocker over the Danbury Hat-Tricks to being outshot 6-3. But a shorthanded goal by Jake Raleigh 10 seconds into a Joe Pace holding penalty has given the Seawolves their 1-0 lead with 12 minutes gone by in that opening period. We'll tell you what needs to happen for Carolina to keep this rampant attack up on the league best Columbus River Dragons. Thunderbirds lead it 3-0. Keys to the second period coming up right after this.
Finish strong. Start here. Atrium Health Wake Forest Baptist.
Maple Chase Golf and Country Club offers the best in recreational amenities in the Triad. Come enjoy a meal at the Pine Brook Bar and Grill. Relax by our pool and cabana. Gear up at the Pro Shop and sharpen your skills on our 9,000 square foot putting green. And play around on our 18-hole Ellis Maples Design Championship Golf Course. Find out more at MapleChaseCC.com.
After 15 years of the Share the Love event, Subaru and our retailers have donated over $250 million to charity. Subaru is the largest corporate donor to the ASPCA and the National Park Foundation, and the largest automotive donor to Meals on Wheels and Make-A-Wish. Get a new Subaru, and Subaru and our retailers will donate $300 to charity.
Want to get in on the action? Bring your friends. With group packages of 12 seats or more, tickets start at just $12 a person. Group packages are perfect for church groups, youth groups, business outings, and more. Come together to see your Thunderbirds. Call 336-748-3949 today.
Use artificial intelligence in new ways to detect strokes earlier than ever before. More peace of mind, since we're the only system in our region that provides pediatricians on demand 24/7. More freedom, thanks to the one and only place around to provide a brain surgery so advanced it requires no incision. Novant Health. Expect remarkable.
At Flo Volkswagen, we make it easy, transparent, and fun to find the perfect SUV. Step into the fun, versatile, turbocharged Volkswagen Taos with 4Motion all-wheel drive and loads of tech at your fingertips. Get into the stylish and versatile Volkswagen Tiguan, designed for every lifestyle. With a wide variety of SUVs in stock, get the right Volkswagen for you. Come in today, schedule a test drive, or shop online at FloVolkswagenWinstonSalem.com.
Here in Winston-Salem, Brett Wiseman alongside you as we get you set for the second period of play between the Carolina Thunderbirds and the Columbus River Dragons. Carolina has, maybe shocking to some, a 3-0 lead right now on the best team in the FPHL. They've gotten to that point by getting not only traffic in front of the net, it hasn't necessarily been taking the eyes of Brendan Colgan away, but it's been getting dirty and greasy and getting active right around the net, right close by. They've been able to stuff home a couple of goals. Got one on a crazy deflection. You throw the puck at the net, good things happen regardless of how long the guy in the net has not allowed a goal, which was in four games total. First goal he'd given up in four games. He came in with a 256-minute long shutout streak that Carolina ended about halfway through, a little bit over that. The first period is Peter Panacek stuffed one home, and then following was Keplinger and Salak. Carolina, Columbus, second period right after this. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
Hey, you can expect more. More days ahead, thanks to the first in our region to use artificial intelligence in new ways to detect strokes earlier than ever before. More peace of mind, since we're the only system in our region that provides pediatricians on demand 24/7. More freedom, thanks to the one and only place around to provide a brain surgery so advanced it requires no incision. Novant Health. Expect remarkable.
Are you looking to reach a larger audience with your business? Bring your business where the people are. There are multiple ways to advertise with the Carolina Thunderbirds. Social media, broadcast, in-arena signage, and more. Over 47,000 people attended Thunderbirds games in 2021-22. Can you really afford to miss out on an audience of that size? The eyes and ears are already here. Your business should be too. Call Carrie Ross at 336-270-1029 for more information.
Whether you're a Division I athlete, an avid runner, or just someone who likes to move, you deserve the expert care of the region's most experienced sports medicine team. We're the official health provider for over 35 pro, collegiate, and youth sports organizations. We offer same and next day appointments, and our goal is to get you back to your game and keep you active. If you want to finish strong, start here. Atrium Health, Wake Forest Baptist.
After the success of the Vanilla Coffee Porter, the Carolina Thunderbirds and Fiddlin' Fish Brewing Company are back with another instant classic. The Thunderbirds Blonde Ale. Smooth and easy drinking, it's the perfect beer for cheering on the birds. Don't delay, because these cans are limited edition. Get yours at the game, in the grocery store, or visit us at Fiddlin' Fish on Trade Street.
Experience engineering excellence in a brand new SUV from Audi Winston-Salem. The Audi SUV family is packed with expressive styling and progressive technology. Make your daily drive thrilling with the performance of the Audi Q3.
Take on new challenges with class and style in the adventurous Audi Q5. Come in today and get 3.99% APR on select Audi models. Schedule a test drive or shop online at AudiWinstonSalem.com.
Three to nothing, Carolina, as the second period's underway. Rowe wins the faceoff, and now a heavy hit up high on Bazarin from Greco. He's got to pick up his stick down as Bazarin, as this one's played ahead. And Bazarin will get off. Played in back of the goal by Cavallari. He'll backhand this up. Picked off by Gill. Storjahan hops on this loose puck. Greco out top, shot was blocked. And now picked up by Salak out to center, taken away by Kelly. Kelly in his own end. Pass too far for Gill. This will be an icing call. Maybe not. Why, I don't know. Pastuca through the legs of Salak. Here's Kelly, shot in deep. Back of the goal, Kennedy. Backhands this ahead. Kelly couldn't touch it. He was going off for a line change. Now Carolina's got numbers. Salak for Rowe. Shot was blocked. Backhanded up and out to center. Jemayev trying to feed that into the middle. Picked off by Carolina. Pastuca hit by Underwood. Pirouetting Underwood. Has his stick lifted from behind by Salak. And now this one tipped in by Doe. Berth for Pastuca. Over for Kennedy. Kennedy banks this out to center. Taken away by Doe. Was hit from behind by Pastuca. Underwood had his stick lifted from behind by Salak as they come together. Panacic lays a hit on the man into the corner. Comes free and now shot down the length of the ice. This has got to be an icing call, and it will be. As Panacic and I believe that's Edgars Oselinge are coming together. They're barking at one another. Bryce French is out there, along with Firth on the back end. We'll see who the five are after the icing here. Kennedy will hop back out. Firth, Keplinger, Ford, along with him, Butita, to the right of the faceoff dot. Keplinger into the circle, where Ford to his left. 18-17 to go, second period. Won by Keplinger, Ford, Firth, now down low. Backhanded out top by Vanelli. Could not be held in by Kennedy. Here's Day, two on one developing. Here's Jemayev. Backhands it on. Cavallari made the save. As Jemayev came crashing into the goal. And Cavallari's going to skate out of the crease, and Paul Jackson's going to have to get out the power tools real quick and fix this one. As it was quick developing, it looked like it might have been a 2-on-1. Turned into a 1-on-0 after the pass from Day for Jemayev, who couldn't ever really settle the puck down to get a clean shot away. Instead, just decided to skate his way through the goal instead of right at it. Seems to be to Cavallari's liking. Firth, back of the goal, gets this out to center. Rogers at the red line, gets it in deep, funky bounce off the stanchion. Ford's able to muscle it free for Kennedy. The stretch pass is picked off. He's able to muscle it back, though. Here's Joe Kennedy into the zone. Banks this off of Rogers, back of the goal. Keplinger, centering pass. Butita forced it on goal, save made by Colgan. Krupp, stretch pass, too far. He'll be picked up by his opposite number, Firth. Not out of the zone, though. Petrantoni will hold it in. He hit his man, Wickline, in the back of the head. And now out comes Carolina. Keplinger near side, dangles into the middle, over for Butita. Butita, cross-ice feed looking for Ford, couldn't get it there. Top of the key, Grebennikov, tipped on goal by Keplinger, and a save made by Colgan. What good play right there by Victor. Alert play at that, just throw it right where Josh's stick was. At the midsection, get the deflection. PV Schnapp, Rowe, Bione, Grebennikov for the five for Carolina. 17-12 to go in the second period. Faceoff won by Columbus. Frejo can't get it out. Picked off by Rowe. Has it poked away by Frejo. Rowe backhands it in deep. Schnapp trying to play this around Frejo. He's bodied up. Gill had his stick lifted from behind. He's able to get it down. This might be an icing call, and it will be. To go here in the second period. Carolina still maintaining that 3-0 lead, and now I believe they may call the icing off. Yes. They'll call the icing off, which on a, I guess you would call it mistake icing call. They bring the faceoff back out to center. Peavy wins it. Bione back of the goal. Grebennikov into the middle for Peavy. Peavy can't quite get this out. Drops it off for Vic. Vic for Schnapp. Schnapp drops it back for Grebennikov. Wrist shot was blocked. This one hits a skate and stays in the zone for the moment. Backhand and out as Schnapp lays a hit on Frejo. Here's Gill, far side. Gill, toe dragging back of the goal, centering pass, no one could get there. Greco wrist shot blocked in front. Bione hops on this, stretch pass looking for Rowe. Here comes Lucas Rowe, skates back of the goal, wraps it around, in front Bione, shoots it wide, rebound Peavy, score! Blake Peavy, 4-0, Carolina! What else can you say other than this is a statement? Four nothing Thunderbirds. Rowe skated back at the goal, shot it to Bione, and now the guy who hadn't given up a goal in 2 weeks has been pulled out of the crease. Go figure. The seemingly unstoppable Brendan Colgan is human again. He's been pulled, and Ty Hunter is into the net. Hunter comes in at 3, even goals against average, 885 save percentage. Here's Salak into the zone. Excuse me. Back of the goal line. Podacic, Pastuka shoots one that's blocked. Cannot quite be held in by Danny Martin. Martin in the middle for Salak, touched over for Pastuka. Pastuka fans on the pass. Hit from behind, and out comes Columbus. Doe. Dangles around a man. Here's Doe in. Save Cavallari. Rebound. Oh, he got it. He stopped it from behind the goal. What a spectacular save by Cavallari. Oh, my goodness. And now some shenanigans, I believe, between Panacic and someone. Magnificent, marvelous Mario Cavallari. Take a bow. Eyes in the back of his head and the back of his pads to stop that one. ...15:31 to go, second period. The Thunderbirds have a 4-0 lead. Schmidt at center. Round stop for Petrantonio, leveled by Firth. Krupp, fans on the pass. Peavy. Played ahead for Bazarin's, picked off at center, shot on goal. Firth. Indirect pass picked off by Petrantonio. Center down in front looking for Wickline. Here's Krupp. His shot was blocked. Gets another one blocked again by Bryce French. French is out with Schnapp. He'll get the red line. Trying to move this into the middle for French. French will touch it in deep, but it was offside. With 14:59 to go here in our second period, we'll take a 30-second timeout. Thunderbirds have added another one. It's a 4-0 lead over the Columbus River Dragons. We're back after this.
Maple Chase Golf and Country Club offers the best in recreational amenities in the Triad. Come enjoy a meal at the Pine Brook Bar and Grill. Relax by our pool and cabana. Gear up at the Pro Shop and sharpen your skills on our 9,000-square-foot putting green. And play around on our 18-hole Ellis Maples Design Championship Golf Course. Find out more at MapleChaseCC.com.
Lead over the vaunted Columbus River Dragons and outshooting them 15-11. So far, 14:59 to go in our second period from a sold-out Winston-Salem Fairgrounds Annex. Faceoff is in the neutral zone after the offside. Panacic will take the draw and win it. Pastuca tried to kick it back to Kennedy, where he and Kelly were tied up. Martin, stretch pass, knocked down at center. Fragio for Kelly. Kelly shoots it on, stick save Cavallari, as Salak trying to muscle his free around Kelly, and does. Ahead for Pastuca, battling along the wall. Martin trying to bank it out. Kelly could not quite hold it in. Fragio ahead for Storjahan. Cross-eyes Kelly. Kelly toe drags, gets inside, and Cavallari made the save. Greco. Fragio shoots it on. Cavallari makes another stop. Boy, Mario has been spectacular so far. Shots are now 15-14. Underwood to take the draw opposite Ford. Underwood wins it. Fragio out top. Gets it in deep back of the goal. Doe. Jemayev back for Doe. Underwood one-timer. Stick save. Cavallari. Stretch pass ahead. Too far for Ford. But it's not going to go far enough for icing. I don't think it won't. This one played out by Fragio for Underwood. He'll backhand this in deep. Smothered on the near side wall by Bioni. Here's Grebennikoff with the crowd getting into it. In for Ford. Keplinger. Keplinger delaying. Toe dragging. Shoots one on. Chest save made. Set out in front of the center. In attempt there by Vucci that was picked off. Fragio. Ahead. Greco for Krupp picked off. Keplinger back into the zone. Takes a whack from Greco. Ford out top. First settles it down for Butita. Butita out top. Bioni touched over for Firth. Firth rips one. That's blocked. Couldn't get it out though. Firth again knocked down in front of the net by Ford, and now could not be centered by Butita. Fragio looking for somewhere to go with this. Doe gets it in. Krupp back for Doe. Cross ice feed poked back out to center. Krupp for Wickline. Watched by Rowe. Wickline for Krupp. Whacked up and out by Bioni. Here comes Rowe. Lucas Rowe one on two. Dangles around one man. Rowe down below the goal line. Takes the hit. Tried to center it for Bazarin. He couldn't get it to him. Petrantonio back of the goal. Leveled by Bazarin, who then takes a hit from Oselinch as Schnapp lays into a man back of the play. Petrantonio laid into by Firth. And now a whistle as Petrantonio's down. He's barking at Firth, and now Firth's going to go off for that. It's a tripping call on Tucker Firth, and the first penalty of the night on Carolina, the first power play of the night for Columbus. And that's not something that this sellout crowd is too fond of at the moment. So Columbus power play, 12:28 to go, second period. Shots are 16-15 in favor of the Thunderbirds. Gill can't win the draw. Kennedy whacks this up around the wall. Kelly picks it off near side. Kelly muscles it in front. Greco stopped a couple of times by Cavalieri and cleared down the length of the ice. Martin Schnapp, Kennedy, and Peavy of the PKers. Kelly with speed through center. Kelly assessing his options. Feeds it back out top for Rogers. Rogers a wrist shot. Pad save Cavalieri. Here's Kelly out top Rogers. Rogers back for Kelly near side. Cross size feed. Storjahan. Storjahan out top. Wrist one that hit a stick and went high. Kennedy nine irons this out, but Gill holds it in. Cross-size feed, sticked out of midair by Schnapp, and cleared down by Kennedy. 1 minute killed, one more to go on the penalty to Firth for the trip. Storjahan through center, slams on the brakes at the red line. Backhand pass for Kelly. Poked away by Salak, and now poked out to center by Panacic. Rogers for Greco. Laid into by Bione. Here's Kennedy. On this, banks it up and out, and all the way around. Almost stolen back of the goal by Panacic. And now Panacic will steal it at center and flip it high and into the zone and kill some more time. Salak forechecking. Here's Petrantonio with 25 seconds left on the River Dragon power play. Petrantonio for Jemayev. Jemayev dangling back of the goal. Out top. Frejo winds up. Jemayev, wrist shot blocked and out of play. It's either Salak or Bione one that got a piece of that. I think it was Salak that blocked it. And that'll take us to a timeout, I believe. Nope, we'll stay here. 10:38 to go, second period. 11 seconds remaining on the penalty to Firth. Ford wins the draw. Can't get it out. Held in at the point. That one tipped just wide by Doe. Ford with three, with two, with one. Penalty's over. As Doe tries to jam this in front, and Cavalieri makes the stop, and Firth will skate right in and have a look at things. ...10:26 remaining in our second period. 18-16 are the shots now in favor of Columbus. But Cavalieri has been equal to the task thus far. Keplinger wins the draw. It's forced out to center. Backhand pass picked off by Keplinger away from Jemayev. Keplinger for Butita, now for Grebennikov. Pass picked off by Vanelli, banked out to center. Grebennikov has it back. Grebennikov around a defender, gets it in deep back of the goal and avoids the hit. Ford levels a man behind the play. That's Ozelinge. Out to center from Doe. Grebennikov, indirect bank pass around Vanelli. Keplinger couldn't get there. Ozelinge played back and now ahead. Jemayev laid into from behind by Firth. Picked off by Butita. Keplinger back for Butita. Butita drops it for Keplinger. Keplinger centering for Ford. Here's Gus. Dangles around. Backhand shot stopped. And Danny Martin can't quite hold this in. He'll try and get this in deep, but it's up and out of play as Jay Krupp went over and gave him a shove. 9:25 to go here in our second period. Take a 30-second timeout. Thunderbirds a 4-0 lead over the River Dragons.
Whether you're a Division I athlete, an avid runner, or just someone who likes to move, you deserve the expert care of the region's most experienced sports medicine team. We're the official health provider for over 35 pro, collegiate, and youth sports organizations. We offer same and next day appointments, and our goal is to get you back to your game and keep you active. If you want to finish strong, start here. Atrium Health, Wake Forest Baptist.
After the success of the Vanilla Coffee Porter, the Carolina Thunderbirds and Fiddlin' Fish Brewing Company are back with another instant classic. The Thunderbirds Blonde Ale. Smooth and easy drinking, it's the perfect beer for cheering on the birds. Don't delay, because these cans are limited edition. Get your...
Rick O'Neill, the radio guy, back at our WTOB radio studio. Thunderbirds a 4-0 lead over the Columbus River Dragons. And this place, the energy has not stopped since the puck dropped back in the first period. It has been loud and rowdy in here all night long. As Salem, one of the Thunderbird mascots, has come up to say hello. Yeah, what's up? Going good? Yeah? That's going pretty good. Yeah. Back of the goal now, Columbus has control. It's played up for Jay Krupp, who's hit from behind by Mazarin. Rowe on the forehand, trying to feather this in front. Kennedy on the forehand, shoots one on, and the save made by Hunter. Rowe picks this back off at center. That's Martin, I should say. Centering pass for Schnapp too far. Now thrown back out to center. Krupp touches it for Wickline. Back out to center now. Rowe sidesteps a hit from Petrantonio. Rowe into the zone. Schnapp was offside, apparently. Looked for sure, at least from up here. Even the mascot agrees. Schnapp's left skate appeared to be on top of the blue line. Carolina off the faceoff. It's Bryce French feeding this one up and out. Pastuca trying to win the race. It'll have to be played from back of the goal as Hunter and Pastuca collided right outside the crease. Centering pass for Storjahan, and he has his return feed picked off by Panacic, who will delay and try and feed it ahead for Pastuca, who will muscle it out. Firth touches it ahead. Played to center by Kelly. He gets the red line. Storjahan knocks this down, hits the break, shoots it on goal, and Gill had a shot at the rebound, but Cavallari controlled the rebound. Frejo picked off by Panacic. Here's Peter, leaves it for Firth. 7 minutes and 54 seconds to go here in our second period. This one does come on goal, and it'll have to be touched. 7:45 to go. Here's Ford. Ford in front. Scores! Oh, gracious! That was disgusting! Gus Ford just turned the entire Columbus defense into a cookout milkshake. Dangling, diving, darting, stick handling, hitting every button on the controller. En route to the fifth goal of the night for Carolina. We'll pause 10 seconds for station identification. This is Gus Ford has made it 5-0 Thunderbirds. With 7:40 to go here in the second period. Who would have thunk it? Rabinikoff at the red line. Gets this in deep, shoots it on goal, and Ty Hunter will make this glove save with 7:32 to go. Ford with an absolutely filthy goal on the backhand. What do we say all the time? Gus Ford doing Gus Ford things. It's exactly what that was for the league's leading point man, turning the league's leading defensive unit into a cookout milkshake, blending them to a pulp on that one. Back of the play, Grabennikoff stretches it ahead for Keplinger. Keplinger settles it down, Butsita trying to center it for Ford. Picked off. Here's Wickline, or excuse me, Jemayev around Bioni in deep. Grabennikoff hops on this. Grabennikoff sidesteps a hit. Ahead, here's Gus Ford with Bioni. Ford leveled out top, drops it for Butsita. Ford will touch this around the wall. Butsita levels into a man. Doe ahead for Krupp. Couldn't settle that down. Kennedy for Peavy. Peavy ahead for Keplinger. Keplinger in the middle for Peavy. Offside is the call. 6:37 to go in the second. It's the second questionable offside call we've had in the last couple of minutes. That one maybe not quite as close as the one with Schnapp, who's to the left of the faceoff dot. Peavy will take the draw and win it off the penalty box and controlled by Kennedy. D to D for Martin. Back for Joe. Kennedy cross-eyes Peavy. Hits the red line, but he has it picked off by Wickline. Here's Cody Wickline. Delays and drops it off. Rogers, a backhand shot. Snared with the glove by Cavallari. And Wickline will take this draw. Petrantonio, Schmidt, Rogers, and Krupp are with him. Peavy, Rowe, Schnapp, Kennedy, and Martin are the five for Carolina as Peavy's kicked out. Rowe can't win the draw. Petrantonio wrists one high off the glass behind the goal. Hops on his own rebound. Gill down low. Petrantonio centering pass. In front, Cavallari somehow was able to push that free to the corner. Krupp. Pass is picked off by Peavy. Schnapp ahead for Rowe. Rowe trying to touch this around Rogers. Martin has to hold up at the line. No, the puck never crossed the blue line. And still it's called offside. The puck clearly never crossed the blue line and still blown dead. Oh, well. Shots are even at 20. Score isn't. It's 5-0 Carolina. Here's Rowe at center. He'll get this in deep. Schmidt around the wall. Peavy pinching. Can't hold it in. Storjahan dangling around Rowe. Ahead for Kennedy. Or excuse me, Kelly. Kelly pop fly. And Cavallari calls off his second baseman and his shortstop to make the catch with 5:37 to go. Shot still even now, 20-20. Which is a number that to both of these teams is always going to be familiar. There was a date in March of that year just before COVID shut the world down that a melee occurred. You may have heard about it between these two teams. Here's Firth ahead for Panacic. Orion Salak. His pass is picked off by Storjahan. Now Salak is back on it. Dangling and stick handling through center. Here's Jan Salak. Down the far side wall. Back of the goal. Salak Pivots back to the forehand. Tried to center it in front for Panacic, who hops on this loose puck with 5:10 to go in the second. Panacic speeds back of the goal. Backhands it off the wall. Bazarin takes the hit. Gets it over for Firth. Now Salak. Trying to muscle this free. Bazarin on it. Keeps the play alive. Salak couldn't center it. Hooked up. And now we're going to get a penalty, I believe. Should be a hook on Frejo. Or not. The penalty is going to go on Bazarin. We'll take a 30-second timeout and figure this out. Thunderbird can still lead it 5-0. In our second period, Bazarin is in the box for Carolina. The penalty is holding, so it's the second power play of the night for Columbus here with 4:48 to go in the second. Peavy can't win the draw. Greco does. Rogers out top, far side, Storjahan. Doe plays it out top. Rogers fumbled it. Kelly cross ice for Doe. Doe for Storjahan. Shoots it. Cavalieri got a piece of it with the glove, and it flew up into the upper level. Make sure everybody's okay over there. Boy, that thing came out and up into the upper level here just to our left in a hurry. Appears everybody's all right. 4:28 to go. 20 seconds killed in this penalty, and now Peavy's been kicked out of the dot. Schnapp fighting to win the draw and does. Throwing around the wall, held in by a pinching Kelly. Down low, Doe. Doe. Storjahan couldn't settle the puck down. Cross-ice feed picked off by Schnapp and cleared. Hunter back for Rogers. A minute 20 to go on this Columbus power play. Storjahan dangles at center. Feeds it in for Greco. Kennedy pirouettes and gets it out. 3:50 to go, second period. A minute gone, a minute to go on the second Columbus power play of the night. Rogers trying to break this out. Stretch pass too far. Firth alertly kicks this ahead. Fans on the clearance. Gets control of it once again and gets it in deep with Salak chasing after this. Thrown out to center by Hunter. Panacic in his own end. Kennedy got the puck out and deep despite taking a massive hit from Wickline. Now this picked off by Salak, trying to center this in front for Panacic, shorthanded. Panacic dangling around a couple. Salak able to hop on the loose puck, kill some more time. In the middle for Panacic. The River Dragon lost their stick. Now Panacic will skate back out to center. 12 seconds. Touched in deep by Salak with 10 seconds on the penalty. Bazarin standing up in the box. Jemayev gets it in deep. Hit by Bione, that'll do it. Nope. Carolina's going right back to the penalty kill as Bione got tied up with Jemayev. And Bione, I believe, is going to go off for a hold now. He was trying to body his man off the puck and just grabbed onto whatever he could before he went down. .245 to go here in the second. Thunderbirds a 5-0 lead on the vaunted Columbus River Dragons. How about it? Third Columbus power play, second of the period, as Wickline's going to get kicked out of the dot this time. Jemayev will come in to take it opposite Peavy. They're tied up in the dot for it. Comes free to Kennedy. Now Krupp, back of the goal, will send this around the wall. Vanelli chips it back for Krupp down low near side below the goal line. Krupp delays. Out top, Vanelli. That wrist shot from Frejo was blocked by Kennedy and now slapped down the ice. Vanelli for Jemayev, for Frejo. Back for Vanelli, dangles around Peavy. Here's Krupp, gets it in deep. Krupp tied up with Kennedy. Panacic trying to muscle it out. Instead, Kennedy does and gets it down the length of the ice. 2 minutes left in the second period. Frejo trying to break out for Cox. Feeds it over for Wickline. That's picked off, and Salak will get it down the length of the ice now. And wait, do we have a whistle? Did that hit the official in front of the bench, maybe? That or it hit a portion of the Columbus bench. Not sure what it hit, but it hit something. And now the faceoff's coming back into the Columbus attacking zone, oddly enough. Minute 46 to go in the second. 61 seconds left on the Bione penalty. Greco out top. Rogers cross ice. Petrantonio back for Rogers. Across for Greco. Wrist one. Stick to side by Cavallari. And it could not be gloved down by Underwood, as now Kennedy will chip this up and out. Petrantonio back of the goal. 30 seconds left on this penalty. Petrantonio gets it in deep. Cavallari settles this down. Plays it up and around. Rogers holds it in. Down low, Petrantonio. Storjahan shoots one that's blocked. And up and out of play. The 20 seconds left on the Bione penalty. And 64 seconds left in the second period. Ford wins the draw. Grebennikov can't backhand it out. Ford's got it now. With a minute to go, ahead for Butita. Butita in shorthanded. Butita shoots it on. That one stick saved. Grebennikov will hold this in at center. Shoot it in deep. And that should do it for the third Columbus power play of the night. They are 0-3. Another successful penalty kill for Carolina. Storjahan stretch pass too far for him, and now it's stuck in the boards behind the net. Martin's got to play it out of there. Almost sand wedge it out. Grebennikov knocked off the puck by Doe. Centering pass too far for Krupp. Held in by Rogers. Shoots it on. Cavallari made the save. And the rebound poked wide. 17, now 16 seconds left. Stretch pass ahead for Ford. Here's a chance. Ford pokes it in deep off a defender. Greco for Doe. Butita couldn't get there with 6 and now 5. Rogers, Storjahan stops out up top, shoots it on. Cavallari save, rebound, score. Kelly puts it home to end the shutout. And with just 8/10 of a second remaining in the second period, Jacob Kelly has put the River Dragons on the board. The problem is they need 4 more of them. PV will take the draw here with just the 8/10 of a second remaining. And one by PV. Now Greco shove snap. Oh boy, here we go. Now Greco's going to be pushed off towards his locker room. Arm has gone up from the official. A 5-1 is our score after two periods of play. We'll see what comes of the situation there at the end of the period when we come back on our intermission report. 5-1 lead for the Thunderbirds over the league best Columbus River Dragons. We'll break down the second period, take you around the league once again, and get you set for period number three. 5-1 Thunderbirds after two. We're back after this. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
Think driving a third row SUV has to be boring? Don't compromise with your next SUV. With an athletic look and performance to match, the Acura MDX is modern, stylish, safe, and designed to thrill. The 2023 MDX adds peace of mind with complimentary maintenance for 2 years or 24,000 miles. Visit us at 425B Silas Creek Parkway in Winston-Salem for a test drive or shop online at flowacura.com.
Ava's Cupcakes is the Triad's sweet treat. The season 4 winner of Cupcake Wars has been featured on Food Network and NBC's Today Show. Ava's Cupcakes are expertly handcrafted with fresh ingredients. Treat yourself today. National shipping available at avascupcakes.com.
Use artificial intelligence in new ways to detect strokes earlier than ever before. More peace of mind, since we're the only system in our region that provides pediatricians on demand 24/7. More freedom, thanks to the one and only place around to provide a brain surgery so advanced it requires no incision. Novant Health. Expect remarkable.
At Flow Volkswagen, we make it easy, transparent, and fun to find the perfect SUV. Step into the fun, versatile, turbocharged Volkswagen Taos with 4Motion all-wheel drive and loads of tech at your fingertips. Get into the stylish and versatile Volkswagen Tiguan, designed for every lifestyle. With a wide variety of SUVs in stock, get the right Volkswagen for you. Come in today, schedule a test drive, or shop online at FlowVolkswagenWinstonSalem.com.
Hey, you can expect more. More days ahead, thanks to the first in our region to use artificial intelligence in new ways to detect strokes earlier than ever before. More peace of mind, since we're the only system in our region that provides pediatricians on demand 24/7. More freedom, thanks to the one and only place around to provide a brain surgery so advanced it requires no incision. Novant Health. Expect remarkable.
Are you looking to reach a larger audience with your business? Bring your business where the people are. There are multiple ways to advertise with the Carolina Thunderbirds. Social media, broadcast, in-arena signage, and more. Over 47,000 people attended Thunderbirds games in 2021-22. Can you really afford to miss out on an audience of that size? The eyes and ears are already here. Your business should be too. Call Carrie Ross at 336-270-1029 for more information.
Whether you're a Division I athlete, an avid runner, or just someone who likes to move, you deserve the expert care of the region's most experienced sports medicine team. We're the official health provider for over 35 pro, collegiate, and youth sports organizations. We offer same and next day appointments, and our goal is to get you back to your game and keep you active. If you want.
We're back here inside the Winston-Salem Fairgrounds Annex. Brett Wiseman alongside you. How about that for a second period of play? Thunderbirds extending the lead, adding one more to the total. Or I should say, two more to the total. As they made it 4-5-0, and then Columbus adding one at the end of the period. So we found out what happened there at the exact 20-minute mark of the period. Right off the goal from Jacob Kelly, which, by the way, came from Alex Storjahan and Cody Rogers at 1959. That made it a 5-1 hockey game off a juicy rebound left out in front although Mario Cavallari has been nothing short of stalwart in his net thus far. Michael Greco and Jacob Schnapp receive cross-checking, matching cross-checking minors. Those are both on the board here to the right of our broadcast position. So we'll be 4-on-4 when we start the third period. Let's take you back through the second, though, if we shall. 3 minutes and 55 seconds into it. Lucas Rowe dangled around a couple of men, skated his way behind the goal, centered one in front. Justin Bione shot one that was saved by Colgan, but a juicy rebound out in front. Left home for Blake Peavy to snipe home and send the seemingly unbeatable four-game shutout streak coming in. Brendan Colgan to an early shower and a date with a baseball cap instead of his goal mask as he was sent out from the net shortly after that. Gus Ford at 12:19 with a goal that kids just dream about scoring. Most of the time they don't score it in real life. They score it in a video game. But when you're Gus Ford, you score it in real life. Pressed about every button on the controller, turned the entire Columbus defense into a cookout milkshake. Put them all in the blender, and then put the puck home on the backhand, top shelf, right behind the goaltender. And then, of course, at 19:59, the goal from Jacob Kelly. Carolina leads it 5-1 after 40 minutes of play. Shots are 25-21 at Columbus, but the Thunderbirds with the more important lead, that is on the goals score counter of 5-1. We'll take it for scores around the rest of the league, and there's a score that's a little bit surprising down in Biloxi, Mississippi. We'll tell you about that and what's going on around the rest of the FPHL after this. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
Whether you're a Division I athlete, an avid runner, or just someone who likes to move, you deserve the expert care of the region's most experienced sports medicine team. We're the official health provider for over 35 pro, collegiate, and youth sports organizations. We offer same and next day appointments, and our goal is to get you back to your game and keep you active. If you want to finish strong, start here. Atrium Health, Wake Forest Baptist.
After the success of the Vanilla Coffee Porter, the Carolina Thunderbirds and Fiddlin' Fish Brewing Company are back with another instant classic. The Thunderbirds Blonde Ale. Smooth and easy drinking, it's the perfect beer for cheering on the birds. Don't delay, because these cans are limited edition. Get yours at the game, in the grocery store, or visit us at Fiddlin' Fish on Trade Street.
Experience engineering excellence in a brand new SUV from Audi Winston-Salem. The Audi SUV family is packed with expressive styling and progressive technology. Make your daily drive thrilling with the performance of the Audi Q3. Take on new challenges with class and style in the adventurous Audi Q5. Come in today and get 3.99% APR on select Audi models. Schedule a test drive or shop online at AudiWinstonSalem.com.
Finish strong. Start here. Atrium Health, Wake Forest Baptist.
Maple Chase Golf and Country Club offers the best in recreational amenities in the Triad. Come enjoy a meal at the Pine Brook Bar and Grill. Relax by our pool and cabana. Gear up at the Pro Shop and sharpen your skills on our 9,000 square foot putting green. And play around on our 18-hole Ellis Maples Design Championship Golf Course. Find out more at MapleChaseCC.com.
After 15 years of the Share the Love event, Subaru and our retailers have donated over $250 million to charity. Subaru is the largest corporate donor to the ASPCA and the National Park Foundation, and the largest automotive donor to Meals on Wheels and Make-A-Wish. Get a new Subaru, and Subaru and our retailers will donate $300 to charity.
K here inside the Winston-Salem Fairgrounds Annex. Thunderbirds a 5-1 lead over the vaunted Columbus River Dragons. Speaking of teams with leads over vaunted other teams that may be unexpected, this one probably more so in that category. The Mississippi Seawolves, who have just 3 wins on the entire season, lead the second best team in the league, a Danbury Hattricks, 2-1 in the second period. Yes, you heard that correctly. Seawolves had a shorthanded goal from Jake Raleigh in the first period, and then added another just 47 seconds into the second. Yaroslav Yevdokimov adding to his lengthy point total, his lengthy point sheet. Yanni Lyriakos and Philip Wong picking up the assists on it. Now, Danbury did add one at 6:44. Brendan Dowler from Daniel McKittrick, and they're out shooting Mississippi 23-17, but their first trip down to Biloxi, not too kind to the Rabbits from Danbury, Connecticut, who Carolina took 1 of 2 from a weekend ago, as their trip down to the Mississippi Coast Coliseum not going according to plan for them, at least thus far, 15 minutes into the second period. 4-2 is our score between the Port Huron Prowlers and the Motor City Rockers. When we last left that one, it was a 2-2 tie. Austin Federley from Alex Johnson and Wyatt Hofflin at 16:29 of the first period gave Port Huron a 3-2 lead. And it's now a 4-2 lead for Port Huron as just 74 seconds into the third period of play after a scoreless second. Lauri Vartiainen from Evan Foley and Samuel Gagnon made it a 4-2 Port Huron Prowlers lead. 33-26, the shot counter stands in favor of the Port Huron Prowlers. Things have gotten out of hand in Watertown as the Binghamton Black Bears have once again made goaltending a nightmare for whoever they're playing. They put 13 up on the Port Huron Prowlers a week ago tonight, and they put 6 up on the Watertown Wolves so far, and who are on their second goalie of the night, naturally. Nikita Voskin in 19:24, the first period from Cameron Yarwin and Josh Newberg. That made it 4-0. Not done, though. Power play goal at 7:20 from Mac Lewis. Yarwood and Juritz the assist. That made it 5-0 Binghamton. Chad Lopez from Nikita Ovoskin making it 6-0 Binghamton. Shots 27-21 in favor of the Black Bears in that in-state rivalry. Elmira and Delaware are tied at 1. About 8 minutes into the second period, shots are 28-27 in favor of Delaware. Chris Hunt had the game-tying goal at 19:20. For Tyler Pekarski and Tim O'Connor for Elmira. 4 minutes prior, Rasmus Asp from Houston Wilson and Danina Malushkin got the assists on the goal from Asp as Delaware was on the board on the power play at that point. So 1-1 is where that one stands. 8.5 minutes into that third period. Carolina heading to their third period, a 5-1 lead on the Columbus River Dragons on Friday the 13th. Ooh, we'll tell you what Carolina needs to do to send Columbus back to the hotel better than Jason Voorhees sent people home from Crystal Lake. After this, this is Thunderbirds Hockey.
Think driving a third row SUV has to be boring? Don't compromise with your next SUV. With an athletic look and performance to match, the Acura MDX is modern, stylish, safe, and designed to thrill. The 2023 MDX adds peace of mind with complimentary maintenance for 2 years or 24,000 miles. Visit us at 425B Silas Creek Parkway in Winston-Salem for a test drive or shop online at flowacura.com.
Ava's Cupcakes is the Triad's sweet treat. The season 4 winner of Cupcake Wars has been featured on Food Network and NBC's Today Show. Ava's Cupcakes are expertly handcrafted with fresh ingredients. Treat yourself today. National shipping available at avascupcakes.com.
Use artificial intelligence in new ways to detect strokes earlier than ever before. More peace of mind, since we're the only system in our region that provides pediatricians on demand 24/7. More freedom, thanks to the one and only place around to provide a brain surgery so advanced it requires no incision. Novant Health. Expect remarkable.
At Flow Volkswagen, we make it easy, transparent, and fun to find the perfect SUV. Step into the fun, versatile, turbocharged Volkswagen Taos with 4Motion all-wheel drive and loads of tech at your fingertips. Get into the stylish and versatile Volkswagen Tiguan, designed for every lifestyle. With a wide variety of SUVs in stock, get the right Volkswagen for you. Come in today, schedule a test drive, or shop online at FlowVolkswagenWinstonSalem.com.
Hey, you can expect more. More days ahead, thanks to the first in our region to use artificial intelligence in new ways to detect strokes earlier than ever before. More peace of mind, since we're the only system in our region that provides pediatricians on demand 24/7. More freedom, thanks to the one and only place around to provide a brain surgery so advanced it requires no incision. Novant Health. Expect remarkable.
Are you looking to reach a larger audience with your business? Bring your business where the people are. There are multiple ways to advertise with the Carolina Thunderbirds. Social media, broadcast, in-arena signage, and more. Over 47,000 people attended Thunderbirds games in 2021-22. Can you really afford to miss out on an audience of that size? The eyes and ears are already here. Your business should be too. Call Carrie Ross at 336-270-1029 for more information.
Whether you're a Division I athlete, an avid runner, or just someone who likes to move, you deserve the expert care of the region's most experienced sports medicine team. We're the official health provider for over 35 pro, collegiate, and youth sports organizations. We offer same and next day...
Wiseman alongside you, getting ready for the third period of play between Carolina and Columbus. The MO remains the same for Carolina, and they'll have more space to work with when a four-on-four gets going. Third period between the River Dragons and Thunderbirds coming up right after this.
Appointments, and our goal is to get you back to your game and keep you active. If you want to finish strong, start here. Atrium Health, Wake Forest Baptist.
After the success of the Vanilla Coffee Porter, the Carolina Thunderbirds and Fiddlin' Fish Brewing Company are back with another instant classic. The Thunderbirds Blonde Ale. Smooth and easy drinking, it's the perfect beer for cheering on the birds. Don't delay, because these cans are limited edition. Get yours at the game, in the grocery store, or visit us at Fiddlin' Fish on Trade Street.
Experience engineering excellence in a brand new SUV from Audi Winston-Salem. The Audi SUV family is packed with expressive styling and progressive technology. Make your daily drive thrilling with the performance of the Audi Q3. Take on new challenges with class and style in the adventurous Audi Q5. Come in today and get 3.99% APR on select Audi models. Schedule a test drive or shop online at AudiWinstonSalem.com.
Finish strong. Start here. Atrium Health, Wake Forest Baptist.
Maple Chase Golf and Country Club offers the best in recreational amenities in the Triad. Come enjoy a meal at the Pine Brook Bar and Grill. Relax by our pool and cabana. Gear up at the Pro Shop and sharpen your skills on our 9,000 square foot putting green. And play around on our 18-hole Ellis Maples Design Championship Golf Course. Find out more at MapleChaseCC.com.
After 15 years of the Share the Love event, Subaru and our retailers have donated over $250 million to charity. Subaru is the largest corporate donor to the ASPCA and the National Park Foundation, and the largest automotive donor to Meals on Wheels and Make-A-Wish. Get a new Subaru, and Subaru and our retailers will donate $300 to charity.
North Carolina, Carolina Thunderbirds and the Columbus River Dragons get the third period underway 4-on-4 after the cross-checking penalties to Schnapp and Greco. This place is still buzzing loud right now. Kennedy back in his own end, number four in the four-on-four. Hits the red line over for Lucas Rowe. Dangles around a man, has it poked back out into the neutral zone. Rowe, little delay. Trying to feed that to Keplinger, but it's picked off by Kelly. Over for Storjahan. Storjahan backdoor Kelly, tipped it wide. Here's Ford over for Kennedy. Playing this ahead on the fresh sheet of ice. Banks this over for Rowe. Rowe for Ford. Doubles back out top. Down low, Keplinger. Back out for Firth. Rips one wide and high. Got a lot of mustard on it, though. Here's Keplinger. Centers one for Firth. Shoots it on, and a save made by Hunter. Firth all alone in the high slot. With a good chance right there. The minute three to go on the matching minors to Greco and Schnapp. Panacic, Salak, Firth, and Pastuka are the four. Panacic wins the draw and forces it down below the goal line. On the backhand, trying to throw this back out top for Firth. He can't hold it in. And now a two-on-one developing. Make that a three-on-one. Wickline for Petrantonio. Delays. Backdoor Wickline. Couldn't settle the puck down. Now Carolina's got numbers the other way. Salak banks this off Ozilage. Salak down low. Trying to throw it back outside for Pastuka. It's picked off by Petrantonio, who skates his way through the center of the ice. Petrantonio shoots. Cavallari made the stop. Oh, gracious. What a save. Larceny with the glove. Petrantonio came streaking through center, and Cavallari said no. .18:34 to go here in the third period. 35 seconds remain on the penalties. Peavy wins the draw, back of his own goal. Kennedy hooked up. Jemayev trying to wiggle around Martin. Take it away from him. Martin killing time back of the goal. Delaying and now ahead for Rowe. Couldn't get a stick to it. Jemayev down the near side wall. Dangles around Kennedy. Kennedy with a nice play to get that away from him. He's able to work this free. Kennedy through the center of the ice. That pass pokes free. Kennedy hops back on this loose puck. He'll backhand it in deep. Schnapp and Greco are free. We're back to five aside. 17:50 to go. His pass touched in by Gill. Gill watched by Grebennikoff, shouldered by him. Bustled free for Ford. He'll feed it ahead for Lucas Rowe. Here's Rowe through center. Dangling around Kelly, centering pass in for Keplinger. Couldn't quite get to it. Storjahan into the zone. Pass for Schmidt. Slap shot was blocked, comes back to him. Kelly hops on this loose puck. Shoots high, sticked by Cavallari, up and into the netting, out of play. .17:20 to go. Here in our third period, 5-1, Thunderbirds lead shots 26-22 in favor of Columbus, but that's about the only thing they're ahead on in this one. Schmidt shoots this one high and wide, back of the goal. Grebennikoff shoulders Doe. Pione trying to muscle this free. Doe and Storjahan battling for it. Keplinger able to swing it past Greco. Banked out to center. Pione's got it. On the backhand, D to D for Firth. Firth, pass was blocked. Storjahan in front. Kelly touched it over for Doe, who backhanded it wide. Brutita's on this loose puck, but it's held in by Storjahan. Poked free by Bione. And for Ford, he'll get it out. Keplinger's after the loose puck. Picked up by Vanelli. Vanelli back in his own end. Plays it over for Greco. He gets it out to center. Storjahan around Krupp. And, yeah, that should have been offside, and it is. Late call for it, though, with 16:26 remaining. Shot still 26-22 in favor of Columbus. Bryce French off the faceoff win for Carolina. Back for Firth. Now ahead French for Rowe. Rowe backhands this in deep. Schnapp is after this. Vanelli has his pass picked off by Rowe, who tried to feed it over off a hit. French rips one as Rowe is having trouble getting up, and that's not a good sign. Rowe will limp back into the play. Schnapp ahead for Rowe. He'll get it in deep, and Warrior is way to the bench. Quick line ahead for Petrantonio. Hope Lucas is okay. As Schnapp trying to muscle this up, and it goes into the bench. And Butita flicks it back into play, but the whistle had already gone. As the Thunderbirds training staff assisting Lucas Rowe there on the bench. Here's Kennedy off the faceoff win for Carolina. Muscles it deep into the zone. Kennedy protecting the puck on his forehand. Moves it in on goal. Is whacked away. Comes free out in front of the goal. Jemayev trying to settle this down, but he's hounded by a series of Thunderbirds. Salak able to muscle this free. Trying to go around Rogers. Banked off of him. Pastuca hops on it. Trying to go out top for Martin. Leaves it down low instead for Salak, protecting the puck on his forehand. Here's Panacic. Backdoor Pastuca tipped it wide. Jemayev out for Underwood. Gets this in deep. Cavallari will not come out of the goal to play it. Kennedy trying to work this out. Martin pokes it out top. Schmidt holds it in, shoots it wide. Cavallari may have gotten a piece of it. Pastuca shoots it down the length of the ice. This will be an icing call on Carolina with 14:42 to go. In the third period, it takes us to our first media timeout of it. Thunderbirds still lead it 5-1. We're back with more after this.
Think driving a third row SUV has to be boring? Don't compromise with your next SUV. With an athletic look and performance to match, the Acura MDX is modern, stylish, safe, and designed to thrill. The 2023 MDX adds peace of mind with complimentary maintenance for 2 years or 24,000 miles. Visit us at 425B Silas Creek Parkway in Winston-Salem for a test drive or shop online at flowacura.com.
In Salem. Shots are 26-23 in favor of Columbus, but the Carolina Thunderbirds have a 5-1 lead on the best team in the league. Cavallari has been fantastic in net tonight for Carolina. Save for the one he gave up. But the Thunderbirds achieved the impossible, it seemed to many. Which was get a puck past Brendan Colgan. They did it 4 times. Kennedy backhands this up and out to center. As superfan Noah Alexander gets the crowd into it with the toga chant. He went with the red toga for the red out. Greco shoots it on goal. That one sticked the side by Cavallari. And now Kennedy will try and shoot this up and out. Gloved down by Butita. Here's John. Shoots and scores! El Capitan! What a shot! Far side! Johnny Butita! his sixth of the season, has made it 6-1, Thunderbirds. When you're hot, you're hot. Butina's third goal in the last five games. ...14-13 to go here in the third period, and the Thunderbirds a 6-1 lead as they get that one back. Stretch pass too far for Ford. Vanelli's on it. Jemayev out to center. Picked off by Bione. He'll get this in deep. Played off the end board by Vanelli. Stretch pass ahead. Petrantonio banks it for Wickline. Wickline shouldered out top. Ford dangles back. Across for Grebennikov. Grebennikov shoots this in on goal. It's gloved and held by Hunter as Grebennikov was leveled by Petrantonio. ...13:36 remaining in the third period. Butina feeds it out in front for Keplinger, jamming away at it. Never got it on goal. Petrantonio on the loose puck. It's going to be held in by Butina. Pass is picked off by Vanelli. Vanelli trying to skate this out and does. Centers it for Wickline. Wickline drops it off for Krupp, and that did end up coming out of the zone. That is offside. 13-16 remaining in the third period. As the Wake Forest Club hockey team is starting to get warmed up down by their locker room, which is adjacent to the main two. They're supposed to play at 10:15, but that might have to wait a little bit. It's 9:48 right now. We still got 13 minutes of this game left. Peavy ahead for Bazarin, that gets that in deep. Lucas Rowe back out on the ice. That is a great sign to see after he took a tough hit in the corner. Gill. Stick handles his way down low. Takes a hit from Bryce French after Bazarin had lost his stick. And Bazarin picks his stick back up and now picks up the loose puck. Banks it behind the goal for Firth. Firth trying to stretch it for Rowe. Underwood picked this off. French trying to muscle it away from Jemayev, who gets in front and scores. Alexander Jemayev puts one home, makes it a 6-2 Columbus deficit. 12:35 to go here in the third. Shots are now 27-25 in favor of Columbus, but they still trail by four. Joe Kennedy stretches this ahead. It's tapped in deep by Salak. Hunter didn't know where the puck was, picked up by Salak. Pastuka, did that go in? Wait a minute. No goal is the call. No goal is the call. Hunter had no idea where that puck was. Salak centered it out in front. Pastuka fanned on the shot and ended up trickling in on goal. But the call is no goal, as now Paul Jackson will have to come out with the power tools to get what? Well, maybe not. Paul's gotten enough airtime tonight. He'll be okay. 12:18 to go in the third. Panacek wins it back. Pastuka! That one counts! What a shot! Oh my goodness! Absolutely ripped it! Bar down from distance! Don't take that one off the board. Carolina's kicked the extra point. It's 7-2. Salak off the faceoff win, taken by Panacek. 12 minutes to go in this one. Kennedy wrists it in deep, banks it off the wall. It's actually up into the netting and out of play with 12:02 to go. Pastuca's eighth of the season. Shots now 27-26 in favor of Columbus. Panacek wins the draw, forces it in deep back of the goal. Kelly can't get a hold of this, and it's going to be an icing call with 11:53 to go. Check line will stay out there. They're humming right now. Shots now 29-25. Favor of Columbus. Kennedy shoots this off the boards behind the net. Played up by Doe for Oselinge. Kelly will touch this in deep off the wall. Kennedy on his backhand. As it picked off by Kelly, centering pass. Vanelli's shot was blocked. Out comes Joe Kennedy. Kennedy dangles and muscles it around Vanelli. Here comes Joe back at the goal. Kennedy delays and heads below the goal line. Kennedy whacked by Oselinge. And now hooked up by Vanelli and down, but he's going to get back on this loose puck. Kennedy backhands around Vanelli. Into the middle. Ford back for Martin. Touch for Butina. Baseball batted out of midair and out of play. .11:05 to go in regulation. And barring a miracle, we shouldn't need any extra time in this one. 7-2 is the lead for the Thunderbirds. Who would have thunk it? The league's best team rolls in here, but they're the ones getting steamrolled tonight. Ford wins the draw, back of the goal it comes. Krupp, near side. Keplinger pinching, holds it in. Ford throws it deep. Rogers has that picked off. Dermeyev ahead for Wickline. Wickline gets it in deep. Cavallari out of the goal to play it. Could not be pinched in. Now it is by Krupp. Ford takes it away from him. Ford dangling around Krupp. Here comes Gus Ford. Ahead for Keplinger. Now for Butina. Johnny Butina stops up out top. Ford drops it back off Butina. Centered for Bione. Couldn't skate around a man. Rogers picks this off. 10.5 to go. Rogers on his backhand. For Wickline, into the zone. For Petrantonio, in front, Krupp couldn't get there as he was tied up by Grebennikov. Keplinger for Ford. Ford dangles around Rogers. Ford gets on the loose puck, tried to center that on goal. And now it'll come back out to center. Ford works his way back into the zone. Delays, works around Rogers, protects it on the backhand, and shoots it on goal, but the stick save was made. Underwood at center has it taken away. Now Rogers, a stretch pass ahead for Jemayev. Too far for him, but is able to hop on it. Jemayev trying to dangle around Firth. Someone lost his stick. That was Firth. Greco for Frejo. Shoots it on, and a glove save by Cavallari. He gets a nice round of applause for his continued efforts tonight. Pause 10 seconds for station identification. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
At Flo Volkswagen, we make it easy, transparent, and fun to find the perfect SUV.
Step into the fun, versatile, turbocharged Volkswagen Taos with 4Motion all-wheel drive and loads of tech at your fingertips. Get into the stylish and versatile Volkswagen Tiguan, designed for every lifestyle. With a wide variety of SUVs in stock, get the right Volkswagen for you. Come in today, schedule a test drive, or shop online at FlowVolkswagenWinstonSalem.com.
Hey, you can expect more. More days ahead, thanks to the first in our region to use artificial intelligence in new ways to detect strokes earlier than ever before. More peace of mind, since we're the only system in our region that provides pediatricians on demand 24/7. More freedom, thanks to the one and only place around to provide a brain surgery so advanced it requires no incision. Novant Health. Expect remarkable.
Are you looking to reach a larger audience with your business? Bring your business.
Period, I should say. Carolina with a 7-2 lead over the league best Columbus River Dragons as this one shot down the length of the ice. Lucas Rowe is going to try his best to win this race, but he cannot as it's iced by Tucker Furt. .925 to go here in the third. French off the faceoff draw for Firth. They want to pop fly this one out to center. Bazarin has it picked off by Greco, whose feed back into the zone is picked off by Firth. Bazarin touches back for French. Feeds ahead for Bazarin. Around Greco. Jemayev lost the handle on it. Peavy plays it ahead for Bazarin, who tried to feed that back for Rowe, but it's picked off by Kirk Underwood. Underwood through center. Dangles around Firth. Underwood back of the goal. Banks it out top for Greco. Greco wrist shot went high. And now a man blows a tire as now Bazarin and Underwood were tied up in the corner. As now a shot from the far side by Frejo was tipped wide. This one off the stick of Firth. Up and down into the netting out of play as Greco and Bazarin have words. Bazarin's going to go after him here. And they'll both be escorted to their respective benches. And now they've given Greco a minor penalty out of all of this. But Carolina's going to get a power play. Third penalty of the night on number 24 in white alone. .836 remains in this third period, and Carolina has a chance to get a two-point conversion if they can convert on this power play. Vast majority of the crowd, despite the score, is stuck around. Some of them Wake Forest students who are awaiting their club hockey team to take the ice just after this one's over and resurfaced. Keplinger, a one-timer, missed just wide. Salak back of the goal. Out top, Kennedy. Near side, down low, Salak swaps spots with Kennedy. Kennedy below the goal line now. Keplinger's got it. Keplinger for Panacek. Settles this down on the backhand for Keplinger. Back out top for Lucas Rowe. Rowe, shot was blocked, Kelly, and that's picked off by Rowe alertly. Here's Rowe, dangles in, shoots one, save made. Rowe not quite able to hold it in again, but he's going to hop on it. feed it through a couple of defenders. Here comes Rowe, dangling in, hooked down. Maybe a penalty shot. Maybe. We'll see. Nope, it's just going to be a trip on Vannelli. The chance was there maybe for a penalty shot as Rowe was in all alone with a couple behind him. But it's going to be a lengthy 5-on-3 here for Carolina with 7:50 to go in the third. A minute 14 on the Greco penalty. As now Keplinger going to be kicked out of the dot. Maybe. Nope. Here we go. 5-on-3 power play. Rowe. Out top Panacic. Far side Kennedy. Back for Rowe. Rowe surveys. Cross-size feed Panacic. Back for Rowe. They'll play catch out top. Panacic settles this down for Keplinger. Keplinger backdoor Kennedy. Couldn't get there. Rowe. Out top. Swap spots with Panacic. Rowe delaying. Drops it all for Panacic. Panacic. Down low, Keplinger, out top Rowe, shoots, save made. That was a shot though. Rowe, back on it. Pass in the middle for Keplinger, plays it back for Kennedy. Now here's Rowe, dangles, shoots, save made. Salak's on the rebound though, and now it's whacked out to center. And Kennedy's racing after this, with Schmidt chasing him. 20 seconds left on the Greco penalty. Salak. For Panacic. Out top. Panacic. For Ford. Ford dangling. Surveying. Shooting. Save made. Rebound. Score! Jacob Schnapp! There's the two-point conversion. 8-2. Carolina. Just as Greco's penalty comes to an end. A power play goal, the second of the night. What a sight this is to see tonight. Beebe can't win the draw. It's picked off by Jemayev. Still shorthanded is Columbus for another 40 seconds. Frejo shot that on goal. It was tipped wide. Now Ford's back on it. Ford. Cross ice Firth. Touches it over for Beebe, who turns on the Jets. Beebe can't get it into the zone. Shot down a length of the ice. A kneeling Cavallari will stick this down. Ford ahead, looking for Firth. Hit the skate of the official at the bench. And that should do it for the penalty to Vannelli. Ford ahead for Schnapp, settles this down. Schnapp shoots it on, stick to side. Peavy trying to knock this out of midair. Putsita's on it. Down low for Peavy, broken stick, back of the goal. Big hit by Schnapp behind the play. And now Schnapp just got hit. Cross-checked into the ice, and now, oh boy, here we go. Schnapp is down and hurting, and Tucker Firth has thrown his gloves off. Butina came to his rescue. Now Butina wants to go. Here goes John Butina, ripping the gloves off a man. And now Ozilic is pounding Firth's head into the ice. As they're having to tear Ozilic off top of Firth. Schnapp is still down. And now here go Peavy and Frejo. Peavy and Frejo. Peavy's held up, can't get his arm free. Frejo over the top. Butina and Underwood want to go too. Peavy goes down, wasn't a lot from that scrap. It is an absolute yard sale right now, but the concern is Jacob Schnapp. as two River Dragons enter the box. Good scrap from Peavy. We'll try and sort this out. As the Carolina training staff went over to take care of Schnapp. And now Schnapp is at the stanchion of the Columbus bench, barking. Bazarin's having words with someone as well. One thing we know for sure, there's going to be penalties. Question is how many and of what variety. Now, if Edgar Zozelinj is still in the game, after the officials had already broken up the fight, he continued punching Firth from behind. That should be a match penalty for fighting after the initial altercation. And a major, we would think. As Butita fought with somebody, so he's going to have to go off. Butita's actually behind the door to the Carolina locker room. He's off the ice. Tucker Firth is back there as well. I didn't see Ozelinj leave the ice. He might have. Yeah, he's gone. So the assumption would be that he's done for the night. With 5:35 to go. Shots are 32-31 in favor of Carolina now. As the Thunderbirds training staff is having to pick up from the yard sale. Still trying to sort this out here. Panacek and Ford are opposite Petrantonio. Right in front of the penalty boxes. Rose taking a knee right at center. This might take a minute. As guys are taking knees at center as we try and sort out what happened is we're missing another glove that belongs in the penalty box to Blake Peavy. That might have been the toughest part of the whole thing, was figuring out whose glove was who and whose stick was whose. And if folks needed a reason to stick around in a six-goal hockey game, they got it. It appeared to us, at least up here, that after Schnapp made that hit and he was cross-checked to the ice, someone either hit him from behind and drove his head further into the ice or gave him a knee or a kick or something. Butita tried to come to his defense and ended up in a chokehold as Underwood's being kicked out of the hockey game. I would think, or that, or he's just taking some equipment over to the bench. Frejo is done. Off he will go.
Yeah.
We're still trying to sort out the total of all of this. The totality, I guess you would say. Blake Peavy is about to exit the ice. Off Blake Peavy goes. Done for the night, it would appear. Now, Carolina's penalty box is empty, but assumedly someone would enter it at some point here. 2 minutes are on the board to John Butita. For what, we're not sure. We wait on all the penalties to roll through. There is a 5 minute major on the board assessed to Underwood. Krupp has entered the box for Columbus. Two are on the board to Butita. Five are on the board to Underwood for Columbus. Which, remember, if Carolina scores in that 5 minutes, that clock doesn't stop. It rolls. It's continuous on a major power play. And now Petrantonio and assistant Thunderbirds captain Gus Ford have made their way back in front of the penalty boxes. And Danny Martin is now going to skate into the box to serve the Butita penalty. Ozelinge, Edgars Ozelinge, that is, has two for cross-checking that at this eventful 14:25 mark. Kennedy cannot hold this in off the faceoff. Match penalty assessed to Edgars Ozelinge for the cross-check. Panagic gets it in deep as the penalty is announced here by Stephen Pond, our public address announcer. Salak and Kelly are battling. He had a feeling it was going to get to that point as Kelly whacks it back of the goal for Finelli. Finelli for Rogers. Rogers, that one batted down by Salak. Now Panagic trying to drop it back for Salak. Salak pokes that free once again. Plays it back for Kennedy. Touched over for Gus Ford. Ford in the center of the ice, looking for Kennedy. Instead, it comes to Panagic. Panagic into the zone. Dangles around a defender. Loose puck. He was tied up, and now this one is whacked all the way out. Pione will race to this. Beat Kelly to it and pop it up. Panagic. Paul Frejo has been assessed a game misconduct. Doesn't say exactly for what. We wait for all the penalties to come through the wires here inside the annex. Bione ahead for Keplinger. Keplinger trying to toe drag around a man. It's poked free. Recco, pass too far for Doe. Picked up by Rowe. Rowe ahead for Keplinger. Under 4 minutes to go in this one. Grabennikoff hops on this loose puck. Here comes Victor. Victor trying to dangle around, hit by Greco. Keplinger out top for Rowe. Rowe slashed by Greco, and there's no call. Bione making his way around, shoots one high and wide. Panacic's got to hold this in. Rowe's glove and stick are still at center, and Greco got away with it blatantly. The second time Rose had to go off due to an injury. And he's not happy on the bench. He just threw his other glove. I don't know how you missed that, especially after what just happened a couple of minutes ago. Pione ahead for Panagic. Trying to feather this through a couple of defenders. Around the wall. This will head back out to center, and Kennedy will have it. Kennedy plays it back for Ford. Ford ahead for Kennedy. Kennedy around the wayward stick. Head for Panagic. In the middle, Salak. touches it deep and a whistle. Timeout. Under 3 minutes to go. We'll have the final few moments here from Winston-Salem. Thunderbirds lead the River Dragons 8-2. The final little bit coming up right after this. And the Thunderbirds have an 8-2 lead. Here's Salak. Plays it over to Panagic near side. Trying to muscle this out. Rowe's back out there again. Great sign. Over for Kennedy. Rowe. Down low. Bazarin. Back out top. Rowe. At the blue line. Shoots it. Tipped in front by Salak. Pinballing puck. Comes free to Bazarin. Petrantonio. Plays it ahead for Wickline. Got a 2-on-1 developing. Wick line. Checked from behind by Panagic. Beautifully on the back check by Peter. And now Rowe's going to turn on the jets and get out. Here's Bazarin. Delays out top. Cross-ice bank pass for Salak. Back over for Panagic. Down low Salak. Near side. Rowe out top. Dangles. Here comes Rowe down the near side. Shoots one. Tipped on. Save made. And now cleared on goal. Cavalieri will stretch this ahead all the way for Lucas Rowe. And offside, apparently, was Rowe. With a minute 43 to go in this one. A minute 8 to go on the Underwood penalty. Shots are now even, 32 all. Martin back of the goal with a minute to go on the penalty. Ahead for Pastuka. Yuri Pastuka down the wall, wires it around. Jacob Schnapp back out there, and now that is a great sign to see. Here's Schnapp. Plays it back out top. Pastuka down low for Schnapp. Keplinger drops it back for Martin. Martin for Ford. Ford delaying. Delaying some more. Assessing his options down the wall. Through the legs of Keplinger, back for Pastuka, who sets this up. Keplinger shoots one on, batted out of midair. And now pop fly out to center with 25 seconds left of the penalty and a minute to go in the hockey game. Here's Schnapp. Schnapp delaying, drops it off for Ford. It comes back out to center. Martin ahead. Might be an icing call, and it will be. With 41.3 to go in the hockey game and 7 seconds left on the penalty, the major to Underwood. January 14th, as we take on the Columbus River Dragons. 41 seconds remain between Carolina and a massive first victory of this four-game stretch against Columbus. Two here, two there. Gus Ford. Ahead. This one not on goal. Schnapp won the race, though. The wave off the icing. Here's Schnapp hopping on a loose puck. Shoots it on, and it's whacked out to center. And Krupp's out of the box. 20 seconds left. French. And that whacked up into midair. Ford ahead for French. Lost it. Kelly plays it back out to center with 10 seconds left. Vannelli plays it back. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Columbus, welcome to Winston-Salem. The Thunderbirds, an 8-2 lead over the best team in the league. And that's a statement if there ever was one. And Lucas Rowe is now barking at Petrantonio. French is having to hold him back. What a performance from Mario Cavalieri in this one, as he and Josh Keplinger have their handshake. Shots end up 34-32 in favor of Carolina. I think that 35-32. And Carolina will salute the sellout crowd. John Butina already put his suit back on. That was quick. And now Jan Salak will lead the line. And a sweet Caroline will ring through the annex as the Thunderbirds have taken down the vaunted Columbus River Dragons in dominating fashion. 8-2 on this Friday the 13th. I'd say that's scary good. Not quite as full as it was at the start of the game, but it is still loud in here, and there's still a lot of red. As Salak and company will finish the lap. Mario Cavalieri ends up with 30 saves out of 32 shots faced. A big night for him. Budweiser postgame show is up next. We'll break this one down a little bit briefly and get you set for what's to come tomorrow night. Thunderbirds win it 8-2 over the Columbus River Dragons. Budweiser postgame show is next.
Think driving a third row SUV has to be boring? Don't compromise with your next SUV. With an athletic look and performance to match, the Acura MDX is modern, stylish, safe, and designed to thrill. The 2023 MDX adds peace of mind with complimentary maintenance for 2 years or 24,000 miles. Visit us at 425B Silas Creek Parkway in Winston-Salem for a test drive or shop online at flowacura.com.
Ava's Cupcakes is the Triad's sweet treat. The season 4 winner of Cupcake Wars has been featured on Food Network and NBC's Today Show. Ava's Cupcakes are expertly handcrafted with fresh ingredients. Treat yourself today. National shipping available at avascupcakes.com.
To use artificial intelligence in new ways to detect strokes earlier than ever before. More peace of mind, since we're the only system in our region that provides pediatricians on demand 24/7. More freedom, thanks to the one and only place around to provide a brain surgery so advanced it requires no incision. Novant Health. Expect remarkable.
At Flow Volkswagen, we make it easy, transparent, and fun to find the perfect SUV. Step into the fun, versatile, turbocharged Volkswagen Taos with 4Motion all-wheel drive and loads of tech at your fingertips. Get into the stylish and versatile Volkswagen Tiguan, designed for every lifestyle. With a wide variety of SUVs in stock, get the right Volkswagen for you. Come in today, schedule a test drive, or shop online at FlowVolkswagenWinstonSalem.com.
You can expect more. More days ahead, thanks to the first in our region to use artificial intelligence in new ways to...
Inside the Winston-Salem Fairgrounds Annex, Brent Wiseman alongside you. Red out night, I'd say it was a success. Thunderbirds had 8-2 win over the vaunted Columbus River Dragons. Three stars of the night, Justin Bione had 2 assists on the night. He ends up with star number 3. John Butina, his former college teammate at Kent State, with a goal and 2 assists. The Thunderbirds captain had to come out in a full suit after he was ejected from the hockey game during that, I guess we could call it a mini melee. Not quite as much of a melee as the last one that these two teams had, but close enough. Butina ends up as the second star, and Gus Ford with a goal and two assists. 3-point night for him as well. He ends up as the game's first star. Mario Cavallari, spectacular in net, stopping 30 of 32 shots for Carolina. There were so many guys to pick from in what was a complete team effort tonight as to who could be the three stars of the game. We'll wrap things up when we come back here on the Budweiser postgame show. This is Thunderbirds Hockey.
Text strokes earlier than ever before. More peace of mind, since we're the only system in our region that provides pediatricians on demand 24/7. More freedom, thanks to the one and only place around to provide a brain surgery so advanced it requires no incision. Novant Health. Expect remarkable.
Are you looking to reach a larger audience with your business? Bring your business where the people are. There are multiple ways to advertise with the Carolina Thunderbirds. Social media, broadcast, in-arena signage, and more. Over 47,000 people attended Thunderbirds games in 2021-22. Can you really afford to miss out on an audience of that size? The eyes and ears are already here. Your business should be too. Call Carrie Ross at 336-270-1029 for more information.
Whether you're a Division I athlete, an avid runner, or just someone who likes to move, you deserve the expert care of the region's most experienced sports medicine team. We're the official health provider for over 35 pro, collegiate, and youth sports organizations. We offer same and next day appointments, and our goal is to get you back to your game and keep you active. If you want to finish strong, start here. Atrium Health, Wake Forest Baptist.
After the
one final time inside the Winston-Salem Fairgrounds Annex. Art Wiseman alongside you. Special thanks to Jose Bahena on the technical side of things, pressing buttons and pulling levers and operating monitors and all that kind of stuff, even when sometimes it's the broadcaster's fault. Logan Allen running our camera tonight. Special thanks to him as well. Carolina has a sellout crowd to thank for a portion of tonight's effort, but mainly it was them. They weren't daunted. They weren't phased. The much-discussed shutout streak of Brendan Colgan was broken and broken big time. Carolina did not care. They didn't listen to any of it. Peter Panacek put that first goal home, and the floodgates opened, so much so that Colgan had an early trip to the showers or the bench, whichever way you want to put it. He was pulled after Carolina's fourth goal. They ended up with twice that number, 8-2, the final over the Columbus River Dragons. Now, especially after what happened towards the end of the hockey game, expect things to ramp up physically tomorrow night, as these two rivals weren't fond of each other coming into this one. And after Columbus got blown out and their shutout streak not just snapped but shattered, expect them to play a little bit determined, just to say the least, tomorrow night. So stay tuned. It's going to be a fun Saturday night. But tonight, Friday the 13th, Carolina doing their best Jason Voorhees impression and slicing and dicing their way through the Columbus River Dragons, sending them home, or back to their hotel, I should say, with an 8-2 loss. For Jose Bahena, Logan Allen, and Rick O'Neill, the radio guy, I'm Brett Wiseman. We'll see you tomorrow night, 5:35 pregame, 6:05 puck drop, right here on WTOB and Thunderbirds TV. One more time, the final. Thunderbirds 8, River Dragons 2. We'll see you tomorrow night.